Welcome to Monday nights. Forgot what day of the week it was, but that's okay. On Hyper RPG, we are here dressed up in full 80s garb to bring you the coolest RPG on this network. Wow, Terry. Remember when I said cool?
It took like half a second for that to be broken.
Man.
I'm like super not clumsy. I'm just...
She ruined the outro. All right, Tara, you're going to do the outro now since you ruined it.
So
or the intro. It's okay. I won't put you on the spot. Welcome to the second episode of The Out Crowd, our 80s themed RPG here on Hyper RPG. I am joined with the Monday night crew here. We'll go around and we'll have everybody introduce themselves and their super unique, awesome characters. We're going to start with Roslyn. Take it away.
Hi, my name's Roslyn. I play Roxy. We're a collegiate cheerleader, high school cheerleader, whatever. Current aerobics instructor, jazzercise to be specific. And her sister Alex has gone missing, and that's what we're working on right now.
Tara.
Hi, I'm Tara. I play Ash. Ash is a little goth, trying to find herself in a little town. She goes to community college with some of these kids. And she was kidnapped by somebody's little sister, tormented, might be a vampire, we're not really sure.
I feel like we proved that you weren't.
I don't know.
Do you want to be a vampire?
You know,
everyone always
said,
wants to be a vampire.
We garlicked you.
It's true.
You've been garlicked.
I've been garlicked, so... But, I mean, she might be into vampires, though.
I'm actually pretty sure you are into vampires.
Yes.
Does seem like your type.
My name is Algernon Bolden. I'm a programmer over at Harebrained Schemes, where we make Battletech, Necropolis, Shadowrun. Go check us out. Over here today, though, I'm playing Zeke, who is kind of the outsider of the group. He's known to sell slightly used VHS tapes and seems to always be at the right place at the wrong time.
Hi, I'm Liz. I am a part-time variety streamer, and I play Mindy, Professor Mindy Benton, a young and, let's say, quirky adjunct at the community college where most of these lovely people go to. I'm also a little bit of a mad scientist. Who are you?
Hey guys, I'm Scott. I am playing Reggie Rakeman, who... Smokes pot, works at the comic book store, takes classes sometimes. Yeah, that's Reggie.
That's Reggie.
Yeah.
Reggie's so very lovable.
That's it.
Yeah. All right.
Wait. Before we start, there's something really important that we want to say. Yesterday was the 1-year anniversary of Jasmine, the Bats Bronze Girl, streaming partnership anniversary.
So we got her. Where are you guys hiding that?
In the back.
We're pretty.
It exists.
What?
The cast was awesome, and they brought this for
what?
You.
What?
Can we eat it?
Yes, eat it.
I'll get some places.
Yay!
Sugar!
Okay. So last week we had candy. This week we have cake. This is a precedent that has been set.
I expect sugar
every week
now. You guys are so amazing. Thank you.
You earned it.
You're amazing.
Worked
so hard.
Oh, I like how the only person who's against us having sugar is the one that has to go home with AJ at the end of the night.
Lizzie's like, give him alcohol, but not sugar.
I'm a chill loser. That's all
you
I'm saying.
You're so sweet. Yes, for those of you at home who are confused. Yesterday was my 1 year of being partnered on Twitch, and I did a 24-hour stream. Still bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, so.
Dang, girl.
Right?
We appreciate you.
Maybe it's because I'm mortal. Maybe it's because I'm the type of creature that Tara is so fond of.
We will never know.
We may never know.
Only streams late nights. Seems to have infinite amounts of energy. I don't know.
I wouldn't be surprised. I'm not going to argue with it.
Look at that. She's into it.
Do we know you're not a vampire?
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Have we seen you eat garlic?
Have you garliced me yet?
No, not yet.
I don't want to garlic you, though, because then, like,
yeah.
Not yet.
Yeah, I'm going to come in one day and just get garliced.
Be ready.
live on stream.
We don't want to hurt her, though. We don't know what those can do.
I'm worried about myself.
Need her. Yeah, what if, I'm allergic?
Yeah.
To garlic.
Then you're definitely a vampire. What do you mean? That's what a vampire would say.
Speaking of exactly what a vampire would say.
That is what happened during last week's episode. To do a quick recap, our sort of weird community college students, professor, random guy who hangs out there, came together at the behest of a really spunky young girl named Alex, who happens to be Roxy's younger sister. And she was convinced of a theory, conspiracy, whatever you want to call it, that vampires exist in Springfield. Now, as we know, all of her quote-unquote tests, vampire tests, failed. But somehow during the entire process of last week's episode, she was abducted in somewhat mysterious circumstances. However, at the time, Roxy's character was really groggy and sleepy, and her mother was passed out drunk. So there's no real good account. Oh my god, cake, I love you guys. There was no real good account on what exactly happened.
God bless.
And because of this, the police are looking into it, but they don't really have any leads. The group decided to come back together and track down some of the characters Roxy had written about in her super secret notebook to see if they could get a lead on where she may have possibly gone. And it is on that sort of page that we open our episode today.
I just got frosting on my sleeve.
Oh, Tara, why you gotta ruin our juju right at the beginning?
No, I'm sorry, you guys. Maybe I'm gonna roll really well today.
You just jinxed it!
Knock on some wood right now!
Gosh!
This cake is bomb, by the way.
Thankfully, you know, the audience will save you guys because you guys already have tons of rerolls
and
stuff.
What?
Because she's nice like that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I can't get it on my hand. They're so small.
Very generous.
Maybe we should actually talk about these.
Oh yeah, we should talk about this stuff.
Yeah, go for it. Guys, discuss your bonuses.
We have these nice little rubber bands that are counting for rerolls. Those are $20 a piece, I believe. If we have any crappy rolls, we can do all the time. We can reroll it one time. You can't keep rerolling. And then on top of that, each one of us has a special ability. For $50, mine is called Bust a Move. It allows me to become incorporeal? I can't even pronounce it.
Incorporeal.
Thank you.
Wispy.
I don't know anything about becoming incorporeal or wisp-like.
Yeah, that thing.
Oh my god.
I'm confused now.
Save us. What? And Mindy's ability is, at the first level, each individual weird science ability allows her to pull a vial out of her bag and drink it and get one random buff or potentially debuff that I couldn't do on my own normally. And if I use three all together, it affects the whole team.
Which is what happened last
time. Yeah, we were all giants and little, and it was amazing.
That was actually cool. Really
fun. I'll always make you guys individually roll for those.
I really like that.
That way, Lucy's good rolls can't save you.
And chat
your
rolls.
Bad rolls will still curse you.
Great.
It's awesome.
Great.
But it was fun. The chat also was rolling with us, which was really cool.
Oh, to see if they were big or small?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god.
So
chat,
really
why
fun.
Are you guys so adorable?
They're like the best. I know. They're
yeah.
really
yeah.
super
so,
big.
Oh, look
small.
At us. We're cute. We don't eat money. So
guys.
I love you guys.
So cute.
Ash
supposed to be educator.
All right. So
Roxy loves you too.
Reggie's power, when you donate, is munchies, which gives him either plus one to presents. Or when he gets three, it's tunnel vision, which gives him a piece of knowledge that he didn't know he knew, and the GM will be in charge of what that
I
is.
I love that.
Yeah, he'll just remember something.
Whoa, wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Did I know that? Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
That's rad.
Roxy's special wristbands give her what's called Let's Get Physical, which is just a plus one to agility for three rolls or for 15 minutes, whichever one happens first, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Depending on
if you're in or out of combat, essentially.
Right, yeah. And then if I get all three, it's called the Full Fonda. And that means I get plus 3 to my agility, which is pretty rad and very useful. And I really appreciate it. Mm-hmm. And I just like wearing the sweatpants.
It looks pretty cute on you.
They're really fun.
It goes with your outfit.
Right?
Mine is candles to candles. So I have these lovely candles. And it'll give me an extra, when I invoke one of these, I get a plus 1 to a boon or bane power level, which is really nice. And then if I use all three, I get to create a seance and I get a little critter or a beast. I mean, totally badass beast. Badass.
Devil bunny.
Devil bunny.
Yep. Those are my candles.
Those are your candles. All right. And with that, are you guys ready to get started?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So we didn't do it off camera, so we'll do it on camera this week. But on three, we're gonna do our out crowd. All right, so one, two, three, out crowd! All right, let's go. So, yeah, we usually do it off camera.
So you don't know how.
You don't know how we are,
just
but now you know
because
we just told you.
Ooh, musical episode.
Yay! That's good because every time I say let's get physical, I just want to let's get physical. Mm-hmm.
And with that, you guys opened up, or I left off rather, so this is where we're opening up. I'm stumbling over all my words today. It's gonna be
you
okay though.
I've been doing a marathon, so.
Yeah, I usually, this week I can use that as an excuse, but I kind of stumble over my words in the intro every week, if I'm being completely honest, but.
Let's get the flow going.
I know. Once we're in, then I'm fine, but it's that beginning part, I'm always garbage. That's okay,
because
I'm good. I'm good at the rest of it, and that's all that matters, right guys?
Yes.
Good finisher.
Yeah.
Yes.
What?
So, you're at the community college. Just gotten out of Roxy's now slightly damaged. Not really slightly, kind of busted up.
Really busted, guys. I only have one card, not
yeah,
full.
And it doesn't look really great.
Does cassette player still work?
Of
a
course.
Little bit, yeah.
More Lauper?
The cassette player does still work. It is still playing Cyndi Lauper.
We need to get her a new tape. Looking at you.
You get out of
I know you have those.
You get out of the car and you're at the community college. What do you do?
Alright, so where does this Rick guy hang out?
Ask this one.
I don't know where he hangs
out.
Yeah,
you're kind of obsessed with him.
No, what? Whoa. Okay. He's attractive. What do you want from me?
I agree, but where does he hang out?
I don't know. I just see him sometimes in the commons, like when I'm doing stuff at the table. So I guess,
to the commons. Let's
okay,
go.
Yeah, we'll go there.
So they head over to the common area of the community college, known as Hannah Hall. It has a small coffee stand in one corner and several circular brown tables spread throughout the hall. And as you're passing through the corridor, Mindy starts to look a little nervous and furtive as she sees her boss, the dean of the science department, start to stroll down the hall and catch a glimpse of her. Miss Benton, are you?
Yes. Yes.
You're here quite late, aren't you?
Yes.
Are you always here so late?
No, it is a recent development.
Students, move along, please. We're speaking with the faculty.
Actually, the reason that I am here is because we have
just
begun.
Just a moment. Students, you're being very rude.
If I'm you gone could just... already.
No, they should stay because the reason that I am here is because I have begun a after-school chemistry tutelage with the chemistry club. It is a chemistry club, and these are the members.
Yes.
A chemistry club.
Yes.
I love chemistry.
They need the grades.
Ms. Benton, you know you're not allowed into the chemistry lab without another instructor present.
No. But, you know, I feel, once again, I would like to voice my strong objection as a chemistry adjunct professor. I would need. But, however, we are not headed up to the labs. We are engaging in book study and in drawing the chemical compositions of various compounds and
so
assigning electrons.
You're the chemistry club.
E equals MC squared, yo.
I was told I'd get
Please
extra credit.
Speak.
I need extra credit. That's why I'm here.
I love chemistry.
She loves everything.
What goes up was come down.
You surely must believe that he loves chemistry.
They said there's gonna be pizza. I joined a lot of clubs.
Don't listen
pizza,
to that
dude.
One.
Do you know how many clubs have pizza? It's great. Like, I barely ever have to get dinner. I just go to pizza.
Well,
club
the
meetings.
Chemistry lab is that way. So, or the, oh, right. Wait, library.
Yeah, yes. We, as you have very unfairly barred me from the chemistry lab without supervision.
Well, we can maybe revisit that at some point. I had no idea you were playing advisor to a club.
Yes.
It's a bit impressive. Most adjunct faculty don't choose to take on such projects.
Well, you know, I care very deeply about the academic success of the students.
You do know that all clubs on campus need to be written off and signed off by several members of the science department, correct?
Yes.
I'm assuming you have these signatures.
Yes.
Okay. That's interesting, because one of them would have to be mine.
Oh, really? Because I was under the impression that just any old two science professors would do. I'm very sorry. Well, if you wouldn't mind, then I will swing by your office tomorrow and get the paperwork, and then you can sign, because surely you will not want to stand in the way of academic progress, young minds, and all of that.
There's a reason for this process. There's a reason for all of the bureaucracy. I know, Mindy, I was your age once.
Well, are we about to go into the process of things again?
We are. Because when you are acting in the capacity of a professor of this college, we have to promise a certain safety, and there's paperwork that goes with this. We can't endorse this club.
They're going to get a paper cut?
With you, I'm concerned they might go home. What was wrong with that other girl? Yes, hiccuping blue bubbles.
I told her to...
Ronnie Feltman, who mysteriously grew scales on half of his body.
You know, they shed very quickly, and he was just fine, and I understand that actually it helped
clear up his
complexion.
We had to pay for his therapy.
The school provides therapy? Man, that's cool for a community college.
Only when there are lawyers involved.
Oh, you have to be pre-law, damn it.
We're at a community college. There isn't pre-law.
There's not? What do you do before law school? Yeah. Wait, you go here now?
Clearly, as she is part of the chemistry club.
Chemistry club. Hey, where's that pizza?
I really need to get them going to...
Mindy.
Yes.
I'll look the other way this time. But... you gotta clean up your act, kid. Or you'll never make tenure.
I aspire to the illustrious position that you have attained yourself and will most definitely...
Dean? That was not... You're lucky if you make like just normal, just full-time professor here. Yeah.
Wow, that was really rude.
You don't really know her rap sheet, children. And I've also seen
your grades. I don't really appreciate the children
grades,
comments either.
So
we're adults.
Fair enough, young lady.
We will be off then.
Stay out of trouble.
Of course.
With that, he...
Later, dude.
See him kind of, you know, swinging his keys around and heading off towards his car.
I am 10 times as smart as he is. And if I...
What'd you do to those kids?
Someday, I will... The scales came off! Honestly. No one appreciates my genius.
Why don't anything interesting happen in the classes I've taken with you? I mean, that's... sounds kind of cool.
Well, you would have to actually show up to the classes in order for you to witness anything that was interesting.
I should come to class.
Pay attention?
Science isn't really my thing. Actually, I really would appreciate extra credit for doing this. Just saying.
We're trying to find my sister. What are your priorities?
It's a science experiment to find your sister. There's some weird things
she's
happening.
She's a missing person. It's not science.
With some weird stuff. She's really interested. It seems sciencey, so
give her some extra credit. We really need her help.
I will give you extra credit in exchange for the assurance that we will not discuss with any outside parties certain incidences in treehouses.
Ugh! That's really unfair.
Take it or leave it, kid.
How? What? I mean it. How am I the only one that thinks that was like not right? That was really bizarre. Really? Nobody? Everyone?
That was the least weird thing, kid. I mean.
First of all, I'm not a kid.
Right? They keep calling us children.
Super really annoying. Secondly.
That was weird.
Fine. You know what? Fine. Who cares if kids kidnap and bound? You know, but I love getting kidnapped. It's great.
Well, there will be no more kidnapping, and in fact, kidnapping is, I think, exactly what we are attempting to thwart at this moment.
Exactly.
We got you free, didn't we?
As you're having this conversation,
could have been a lot worse.
You approach the hall, the doors of Hannah Hall, and you go inside, and you find, for the most part, it's mostly empty. There's a girl cleaning up her sort of barista stand for the night, and a couple of people studying at tables, and that's about it.
Where's Rick?
I usually sit over here.
Mindy, I'm going to make my way over to the woman cleaning up the barista stand. Hello.
Oh, sorry, we're closed.
No, that's
closed.
Fine. I actually just have a question.
No, sorry, no orders right
have
now.
Have you
we're
seen
closed.
A young gentleman? Very.
He's attractive.
Okay,
he's
what
pretty
part
hot.
Of like we're closed? Not.
I'm not trying to order.
I'm not on the clock.
I'm not trying to order.
I know you're a teacher, but that doesn't mean. Oh, hey! How's it going?
What up, girl?
What's up?
How do you like that last tape I sent you?
I loved it!
I got a new one for you. It's called Coming to Africa. It just came out this week in theaters.
Amazing! So, thanks!
I just thought about you when I saw this.
Thank you!
Can you do us a
How
solid?
Are you doing? Do you want a drink? I can fix you up something real quick.
You are just so
The
precious.
Machine's still warm.
Thank you.
Sweet, yeah. What do you want? You want like a mocha? Or?
I was thinking like a triple decaf, you know, with the two shots like you normally do.
Yeah, I gotcha.
Yeah, no, seriously though.
Uh-huh.
We're looking for, you know, like that guy with the, you know, earring who, you know, looks all pretentious with the leather jacket?
He sucks a lot.
Oh, Rick. Yeah.
Have you seen him lately?
Yeah, he's usually around this time.
Really?
He comes and he goes. I don't actually think he takes any classes here.
No, I just think he picks up on chicks here. Really?
Well, I mean, it works, so.
Sorry.
I'm still waiting for him to, you know, saunter over my way, but I don't really think he's into coffee.
I don't know. I think he likes coffee very much.
I think I... Wait.
It's okay.
No, he's definitely into that, like, super pale, gross-looking type.
You don't say.
Yeah. Mm. Mm-hmm. I mean, well, look at him. He's really pale. Usually not my type, but with Rick... There's something about that guy.
You don't say. Seems he has all the ladies kind of a quiver. It's like, what's with him?
Ask where we can find him.
Ma'am, I already told you we're closed.
girl, look, where can we find him?
I don't know. Well, I mean, he's like around.
Just keep an eye out for me, and next week, I got a new hotness for you.
Yeah, I mean, I'll tell you how I feel about Come to Africa. It sounds amazing.
Gotcha.
Thanks, man. I'll finish your coffee, and I'll send you on your way.
Okay.
Yeah? So, it just turns around.
What's the status on that pizza? This is like the worst club meeting I've been to.
What? Whoa. Are you serious?
No club.
Wait, so there's no pizza?
No, you made up the pizza.
Damn it.
You were the one who came up with that idea.
That was a good idea.
It was a good idea, but like, dude. Okay.
What?
Oh, hey, Reggie, do you want a mocha too?
Nope. Oh, yeah, what's up, girl? Sure.
Hey.
How you
How's
doing?
How's it going?
I'm doing good. Good to see you again.
Yeah. How's your studies going?
My what?
I kind of see you around. We were in like philosophy together.
Oh yeah, philosophy.
But then you just kind of stopped showing up.
Yeah, you know, I feel like it. I just thought that I had like philosophized enough, you know,
I could
for a
see
while.
That.
I think
really
I got.
You're really zen.
I do a lot of thinking. And
yeah.
Meditating. I
mean,
I guess
you basically taught that class.
Yeah, yeah. You
know,
it's
you kept
about...
interrupting the professor and going on about your own theories on, like...
Yeah, well, he was just being so mainstream about it all, you know?
Yeah, no, I agree. Yeah, I really dug it.
So I had to get out of there.
Yeah. I understand it. Yeah. You want your usual?
So you close it down. You're off soon?
Yeah, I am. Yeah.
You got any plans tonight?
No, not really.
Yeah, how much longer do you think we'd wait for it?
I don't know. It could be a couple hours.
All right.
I just got a movie. Maybe we could watch it.
Yeah, baby. Tell you what, I'll give you a call. I still got your
Does
number.
He frequent Sweet. This establishment with other women or
Ma'am,
people
we
that
are
you
close.
Are there people that we could talk to find him?
I'm just going to turn around and pretend like you're not here because you're embarrassing yourself.
I don't understand.
I get that you're faculty, but closed means closed. Okay? Okay.
You're very vexing.
I don't even know what that means.
Yes, I imagine you would not.
All I know what it means. It means you're not getting coffee. Just
I don't want coffee!
Just turn around, your little gobble
head. Information.
Just walk that.
Ask her!
Is she bothering you guys?
Can you give me a moment to go?
Actually, I can go for one too.
These are friends of mine. Look. I don't normally do
Hey, Roxy! How's it going? How
right?
are you?
Great, how are you?
Good! It's so random that you're back!
Yeah, tell me about it.
Well, you know, sometimes that stuff just doesn't work out.
Yeah, some things don't work
I won't
out
cry about it. You seem awkward about it, so I'm not gonna cry about it.
That's great, thanks.
Yeah,
I really appreciate that.
Yeah.
Can I have a white mocha?
Yeah, of course, yeah. And
I need like a couple extra shots,
too.
That'd be great.
Yeah, I got it. Where's Alex today? She's usually around here.
Actually, that's
not
my,
gonna
lie.
That's I know why you paid me like $50 last month to not give her coffee, but...
Yeah, because
she's
she just
so
stop, she won't stop talking. When...
I know. But she's so cute and she's so persistent. No. I may have cheated once or twice.
That's okay. But actually, like my professor friend over here, she was asking about Rick because I can't find Alex.
Roxy.
I know. I said
Why
she's my friend. And
she's not your friend.
No, she's actually sister. Really nice. She is. You shouldn't be
Thank
so mean.
You. Why are you hanging out with her?
Ooh.
Roxy.
I'm also learning that she's nice, even though she's kind of scary looking.
Roxy, can we just have like a moment over here, over to like the side of the stand?
This is just so that I can find Rick, okay? I'll be right back.
I see.
So,
it's not like
why are you like okay? I get Zeke, I get Reggie, but like. Why are you hanging out with Little Miss I Cut Myself? And a teacher. Like, are you like a group now? Are you like a clique now?
No, I'm... They're helping me find Alex.
Is Alex missing?
Yeah, she's like totally missing.
Oh my god!
I know!
How?
She's like a missing person.
How do you lose her? She's so loud!
I know, right?
Who would take
no,
her?
No, she like she got taken out of our house last night and...
What? Did you call the cops?
Yeah, and they totally like didn't believe me.
So you're gonna do like some vigilante like justice,
no,
right?
I don't... I mean, when I find whoever found her...
I saw you throw down with those guys about the bike.
I try
do
not...
Do you think they took her?
Oh, we haven't tried them yet. Maybe we'll go to them next. But I'm trying to find Rick, because I think Rick might know someone. It's kind of a long story.
You think he's friends with those bike guys?
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh. Well, I mean, I gotta be honest. I haven't really seen Rick all day.
All day?
Yeah, well, he doesn't come by every day.
He
doesn't really go to school here. Just kind of comes and hangs out.
Well, maybe if like,
some of his like friends come and hang out here, though.
Did you see them today?
Well, yeah.
Maybe actually, I've got an idea. Can
they
I
smoke out back? Oh, near the parking lot.
Okay, thank you. That's super helpful. Yeah. We'll go check out there.
They usually ride their motorcycles and park them over there, and they kind of smoke and hang out.
Okay.
Kind of gross. You're not allowed to smoke on campus.
Yeah. What if I leave my number and you can like pretend like I'm trying to get a date with them? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then like then maybe they'll call me when you see them next.
You mean Rick?
Yeah.
Yeah,
specifically
sure.
Rick.
See, you know.
Yeah.
Rick was talking to, like, Little Miss, I'll burn your house down the other day.
I know, they're, like, friends, I think.
Okay, I hope
she keeps talking like they
because
are.
He is, like, and she is, like, ew.
She's not ew. That's not very nice.
She's a little, she's, like, a little.
She's, like, into, like, the black makeup stuff.
Yeah, like, she needs a baby wipe.
I know.
Like, just.
I'll, maybe
wax
I'll,
on,
like.
Wax off on her maybe, whole damn face.
Maybe after this adventure, we'll, like. I'll work on that. Maybe I'll do a makeover. That'd be fun.
That would be like charity. I feel like you could write that off on your taxes.
She doesn't need it that bad. Okay.
She kind of does.
She's
you're
fine.
Too nice. Roxy, you're so nice. Here's your mocha.
Thank you. Thanks.
All right. Oh. Well, it was nice talking to all you guys.
Can I get a mocha for her too?
Oh, we're closed.
Yeah. You know, I'll just share this one with her. Do you have another cup?
Yeah, sure.
Can I have just another small cup?
Yeah, I'm going to give it to you so you don't have to share because, like, the...
I don't think she has germs. It's fine. Well, although she does wear dark makeup, so.
She does. Yeah. You don't want that all over your beautiful face.
Thanks. It was really nice running into you.
Hi. Hello, Ashley.
She likes Ash.
I know.
I thought...
Hi, Ashley.
Have you learned something?
Yeah, so apparently the guys smoke
see
out back.
Staring
so we should go
me.
Check them out. See if
oh, those
out
dudes?
Back. Yeah.
Dudes. Did you notice that?
I did.
You noticed I that staring at you?
Let's Rick's friends it. Are kind of be there out
let's
there.
Be let's be on our way then. And Mindy grabs Ash by the collar.
Rude. Yeah. It's great that you're telling
tries
me.
To pull
who
her
is
off.
Rude here. You're the rude one.
Rude
I'm pouring some coffee for her.
That's great. Well, I was
to Ashley.
To the parking lot. Not Ashley. I don't know who that is.
Can you stop, please? We need her.
Yeah, they need me.
Okay.
She just ducks behind her little barista stand and continues to close it down.
Sorry, she's kind of like, not nice.
I'm gonna put a hex on that girl. She's kind of a jerk.
Well, that's a little extreme, but
there is no such thing as hexes.
Okay, scientist.
There is such a thing as science.
She can't raise a scientist.
Yeah. That's why I don't go to your classes, but it's fine.
I'm going to lead the charge out to the back.
Okay.
Potentially so, the guys are out.
You go out the back doors of the hall, and now you're out on the parking lot.
Thank you
and
for the
you look around, and for the welcome. Most part, it is like it's deserted. There's a few cars in the lot because some people are staying late and studying for who knows what. And then you sort of notice, sort of in the back corner that the barista was describing,
mm-hmm.
that there is like a lone bike parked there.
There's one?
Yeah.
Like a pedal bike or a motorcycle?
Huh?
Like a
motorcycle.
A unicycle. Mm-hmm. A unicycle.
I mean, it could have been a pedal bike. I don't know.
Tricycle.
Does it look like the one we saw in the photos?
But yeah, it could be just... Could be mistaken for one of those. The photos were kind of blurry.
I mean, it's not unusual to have a motorcycle.
But like, I don't know. I mean, what if it's his?
You could leave a note on it.
You could leave a note on it.
While they're arguing, I'm just gonna step away and
we're not
just...
arguing, we're discussing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna go head around the corner.
And just high scope out to see what's there.
Okay.
Just casually.
They can't wait 2 seconds while we figure something out.
Are you guys standing by the bike?
Yeah.
We're walking towards the bike, yeah.
You're walking towards the bike, and where are you headed?
We're just kind of walking around to flank it.
Okay.
Mindy will stick with them.
Okay. Reggie?
Well, I'm following Zeke.
Okay.
Yeah.
I guess we could leave my home number for them to call, or should we leave your home number?
I really
perhaps if
want
you make the note somewhat illicit, then he will phone you back very quickly.
Yeah, but we have to go to my house.
And like wait there.
Ugh. Or should we go to your house?
Well, I did leave my number with the barista. So that she could call me if
Mindy smacks the bike.
Why are you touching it?
What are you doing?
Not to knock it over. Just smack it.
What are you doing?
Because alarm systems were a thing. Are a thing.
What? Sure enough, the lights, sirens.
Oh my god.
Or not sirens, but you know what I mean.
No, they think we're stealing
alarm
the bike.
Alarm system starts going off.
On the other side of the parking lot, I turn to you and go, oh shit, are they trying to steal that bike?
Go, my god, Reggie.
Think so.
Sure enough, you see a sort of short gentleman start walking up. He has a blonde mullet with some feathers braided into it. So his hair is braided in on the side, and feathers braided in.
I have made a huge mistake.
And he's kind of short, you know, and he's very serious looking. And he walks up wearing sunglasses, and I was like, hey, what the hell?
Sorry, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, get away from my bike. Why are you?
I thought this was my friend Rick's bike. I'm sorry.
Your friend Rick?
Yeah. You know Rick.
Something tells me you're not Rick's friend. Can you guys move along? Get the hell away from my bike!
Fine.
Wait, do you know Rick?
What is with you girls being all over Rick all the time?
I mean, you have
Listen,
eyes.
Listen, sister. Can you just back away from the bike?
You can't answer a simple question?
You can't simply back away from my goddamn bike?
I'm not touching anything. I'm just standing
Well,
here.
My alarm system says the contrary. So can
It was
away
an accident.
From my bike.
I'm accident. Not near your bike. I'm asking you a question.
Yeah, I might know Rick.
You know where he is?
I'm not just gonna give away Rick's address to a bunch
of
randos.
I don't want his address. I'm just wondering where he is. Normally he's here.
Lady,
he's
I'm
here.
Not his keeper, all right? With this, he kind of leans over and turns the alarm off and starts to swing one leg off the bike while rudely sort of pushing you guys aside.
Hmm. Go use your charms on
she
him.
She wishes to have illicit relations, and if you could facilitate that,
Whoa!
Then she would appreciate it.
What?
Surely Rick would be very...
Are these your wingmen?
No. This is really embarrassing.
Thankfully for her, no.
This is really embarrassing. This is already really embarrassing for me. This is not... That's not rad. Okay?
Yeah, something tells me you're not really Rick's type.
Ugh.
How are we both not his type? We're like opposite ends of the spectrum.
There's a gray area in the middle.
Oh, he likes the gray
Rick's
area.
Type?
Okay, fine. I think we're both his type.
Yeah, I don't think you understand.
Well, either way, I'm not going to give out my homie's Rick's location. Obviously, if he wanted you guys to know where he was, you'd know.
How's he going to feel when he finds out that you, like, all these women wanted to talk to him and you're
And you totally cock-blocked him.
Considering he doesn't have a hard time getting women, I think he'll sleep okay at night.
Okay, really though, like, we need to find Rick because I think he, what?
He's turning the bike on.
Give Please, it a couple kicks. I really need to find Rick.
Why?
My sister is missing. And I just,
and?
I have this feeling that he has some ideas. It's kind of a long story, but she's my baby sister and she's been missing like almost a whole day and
I mean, come on, man. This is really serious. Do you think we'd hang out otherwise?
Like, for reals.
Like, why do you...
How is Rick supposed to know where your sister
He's
is?
He's one of the last people that saw her. Come on.
So you think Rick saw your sister?
No!
We just think that she might...
He might have information of who might have else have seen her.
Yeah.
Right, because shady kids with leather jackets and motorcycles steal kids.
What the hell are you talking about? That's not what we said at all.
We're not like typecasting him or anything. We're just like, we think
Unlike
he might have
us.
An idea. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's fine. Telling us who, what type we are and what not. Do you know Rick's type? No, I don't bet your name in that.
Considering I hang out with him every day, I think
Yeah,
I would.
I'm sure.
So you know where he is? Please.
Listen to the nice one.
Please.
Look at that face.
I'm really just trying to hunt down my sister.
You need to get your things, whatever they are, in line.
Rude.
Are you even a student? What are you doing here?
It's none of your business.
How old are you? You're like ancient.
Still none of your business.
What are you doing here?
What was Rick doing here?
Doesn't matter.
All I know is you guys have got your story all mixed up. One second you want to sleep with them, next second you want to interrogate them.
We want to do both. What?
Okay,
exist. I don't understand.
I am exclusively trying to find my sister.
I mean, you all... Really? Okay. Come on.
I know. He's cute. But, like, I really am trying to find my sister.
That's priority number one.
I am not trying to sleep with her.
But then priority number two.
Yeah, I'm not sure why she's deal? Not.
Why are you guys hanging out around my bike? Listen, I just don't really appreciate whatever the hell it is you're doing here.
We go to school here.
I mean, again, around my bike.
That was an accident.
Sunshine.
We told you what happened. It was just a misunderstanding on whose bike it was.
We were looking for Rick. We know he drives a motorcycle. Apparently you're friends with him. You're being really weird about it. Yeah. I just want to talk to him.
Well, you kind of got to be in with his group.
What does that mean?
Like,
means we got a kind of clique thing going. Not just anybody can come and kick it with us.
We're not trying to kick it. Okay. She's probably trying to kick it, but I'm just trying to, like, get some information on my sister. And if in the process she ends up making good friends with Rick, then that's fine.
I also just want to help her find her sister. If other things come of it, I wouldn't complain.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Just, like...
Can you at least give him a message that we, like, want to talk to him?
Yeah, that would be great.
Sure. What's the message?
Oh, we want to talk to him.
And so, you guys will beware.
Here. I grabbed on my purse notebook to write out. Should we give both our numbers?
Yeah, but, like, then we have to go wait by a phone.
I mean, this is so cringe.
Sorry, we have things to be doing. Why don't we give him all of our numbers? Like, maybe your office number in case we're at school.
Do you have an office number?
No, I am an adjunct. Okay. I don't have an office. They took it away from me after the incident with the Miller kid.
Okay. What? Do you have a home?
Yes.
Can we have your home number?
Yeah, can you write it down for us?
I am already in, whatever. Sure.
Okay.
So we're all going to write down all our numbers.
And then just let him know to try calling us.
And just tell him, we're just trying to talk, figure out where
he'll get right to you that.
You know, you don't have to be so mean.
Are you girls for real right now?
Yeah.
How many wrinkles do you have?
None.
You're like super old.
He's actually looks amazingly young.
Does he? Mm-hmm. I don't care. I'm still gonna say that to him.
He has a little bit of pale skin.
Yes.
And some sallow eyes. But other than that,
you have somewhat of a vitamin D deficiency. Possibly anemic.
Some people don't like hanging out in the sun, Professor.
Yeah, he just kind of seems like a nighttime kind
of
dude.
All of you are weird.
Oh, and you're not?
No.
Whatever.
What would be described as cool. Anyways,
a cool person would do that.
I've got places to be, things to do, and there's an amazing sax concert I'm on my way to. So
amazing what?
Never mind. He just kicks on his bike, not wanting you to follow him, and rides away.
Can we try to figure out where he's going from the direction?
You can try.
Why don't we sprint to my car and get in it and try to car chase him?
I definitely wrote down his license plate number.
Ooh, okay.
On his bike.
Okay. His bike is pretty loud.
Where did the others go?
Oh, we were watching this entire time.
Yeah, we were watching from afar, making sure.
That's embarrassing.
I would assume we're probably leaning
was,
up
like,
against Roxy's car.
against
Roxy's car.
What a jerk.
Oh, are we in the same parking lot that I parked in?
Yeah.
Oh.
Further away, but yeah.
Do we want to try to
follow
him?
Yeah, let's follow him.
I'm certain he won't notice that at all.
Minnie
says this as she's going to the car.
Have you guys ever seen Beverly Hills Cop? You just turn off the lights and you follow.
Oh, good idea. My headlights don't work anyways because we got in an accident.
All right.
So.
I'm not happy about that. That's my favorite.
Did you guys figure anything out?
No. Except he's going to a sax concert.
We figured out that he thinks that they're spazzes and that he is very much rad.
And
he's not that rad though. He's not that rad. I bet he's like not even friends with Rick.
He said he's friends with Greg, and I don't think he would, like, lie about that.
I don't know. He seemed kind of like a jerk.
Sax?
Yeah, he was. Would either of us know about these sort of things?
Yeah, that's a good call.
Okay, yeah, like, wait.
I mean,
show,
especially you.
That show at the pit tonight?
And you feel like you've seen this guy in the pictures before.
Oh, right. He usually hangs out by the beach area.
Yeah.
By the beach. Wait, do you know of any concerts going on tonight that we should go
to? Yeah, at the pit, they're right by the beach. They always have shows going on.
Perfect. Let's go there. We don't even have to follow.
Yeah, that sounds like fun. I'm down.
What time is it?
You would know that. Yeah.
There is that one problem that it's like usually the cool people that hang out there.
Are you looking at me?
No. I'm just saying in general.
Who are you talking to right now?
Just making a statement. Chill.
Sound very nice.
I agree.
Whoever you're saying it to, I don't like it.
I agree.
I could have included myself in it. I'm just saying.
I don't think you were. Because you are obviously cooler. But never
mind. Thank
you. Anyways. What time is it at this point?
It's about 8:30.
Okay, so are we gonna go to said place?
Let's go to the beach.
Let's go to the beach.
Is there gonna be a phone there?
Might be a payphone.
It's the boardwalk.
There might be a payphone.
Do you think there's a payphone there?
Why? There's definitely gonna be a payphone at the boardwalk.
Well, there's a payphone. I can't promise
that
it works.
Watch an 80s movie.
Okay, good. as long as I can get the payphone.
I'm just kidding.
Kids these days.
What do you need a payphone so badly for?
It doesn't matter. Don't worry about it. It's fine. Let's go.
It's not like they're gonna have the number of the payphone.
I have to call my friend. So...
Oh.
I have to call my parents. I still live with them.
Yeah, me too. Okay,
well, you guys still live with your folks too?
Wait, you guys don't have to call your parents later? Like, you don't have a curfew?
I do not live with my parents.
No. I went away to school.
That's great. I hate this town.
Okay, my parents live with me.
I agree.
Okay.
Keep telling yourself that now. To the boardwalk.
We're ready.
To the boardwalk.
So we all pile in my car?
Yeah, so you're not gonna follow him?
No, we'll just go to the boardwalk.
Okay. That
sounds like too much work.
And Reggie, you know where the pit is?
My car's probably really loud.
Yeah.
Anyways.
Okay.
They go to shows.
Yeah.
Do you know where
the pit is? Will you remember?
Wait. Yeah, it's over there.
You guys drive to the boardwalk.
Sit
where
in the
it's
locker.
Like, yeah, it's like things are popping this time of night. Thursday, Friday night. And Ferris wheel is all lit up and there's rides and shops and all kinds of stuff going on. And you park your car and walk past all these wonderful attractions and past the arcade and the cotton candy and the electronics store and all this cool stuff.
As we're walking, I'm gonna pull a joint out from behind my ear and light it up.
Okay. And as you're walking down the boardwalk, Reggie sort of directs you to the pit. And when you get there, you see like kind of pyrotechnics from far away, and you hear like really inspiring sax music playing over the crowd. You hear people kind of yelling and shouting, and you sort of turn a corner and you see almost what does look a little bit like a pit right there on the beach. There's sand and ocean. And in front, there's a stage with lights and pyrotechnics. And there is a man wearing no shirt and leather pants. Very muscular man. And he's totally, like, shiny, like somebody rubbed grease all over his body. Just greased up dude with slicked back hair and a ponytail and a nice big, like, chain. And he is playing a sax and pelvic thrusting right up there on the stage. And the crowd is going crazy.
Quite the visual.
I'm so confused right now.
He's kind of great, though.
Is he great?
Yeah.
We have different definitions of great. Oh. What?
He's quite symmetrical.
Oh, I don't like this.
Symmetrical? Oh my god.
I feel very uncomfortable. So what are we gonna do now?
Find Rick?
I'm gonna start looking around to see if there's people in leathers. They're all hanging together.
I'm just gonna get to the back of the crowd and watch the show.
I'm gonna go find you guys. I'm gonna go call my parents real quick. Just let them know I have to
be out later. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Okay, I need to go find a payphone.
Okay, so you go and you look around, and about, you know, some ways away, you do see a payphone.
Okay.
What's it? What do you do?
Head to the payphone. Mm-hmm. By myself. You guys are gonna be here, yeah?
I'll be here.
Okay.
I don't need to listen to your parents.
No, I know, but I just like don't want to come back, and you guys are like gone, and that thing. Just, ugh.
It's kind of hot.
We've bribed you. We won't leave you.
Okay, thank you. Okay, go to the payphone.
Okay.
By myself, I guess.
All right.
And call my parents.
Okay. Phone ring. What do you say?
Do I get them? Are they on the line?
Yeah.
Hey, Mom.
Oh, hello, darling.
Yes.
Where are you? It's almost dinner time.
I'm out with friends.
Ashley.
It's Ash, Mom.
I made your favorite. I made your lasagna that you like.
Oh, I do like your lasagna. can you save me some? I'm going to be out late tonight, I think.
All right, if that's honey. Okay. You know we support you. Just you be safe, and you do what you need to do, and know like, that we love you.
I take the phone, and I'm like gagging myself in my head.
And we'll be here for you the whole time, okay?
Okay, Mom.
All right.
Okay.
You'll be out too late.
Okay, I'm going to be out late.
Oh, you're such a precious girl. All right.
She's a mom.
I love you.
I love you too, Ashley. Be careful now,
it's
all right?
Ash. It's Ash, Mom.
Be careful.
Remember, you said you...
Okay,
you
Ash. Said, all right, then.
You said that... I mean, we've gone over
this
a lot.
Bye-bye.
You just say, I now have this image in my head of your mom, like, with one of those, like, fully hairsprayed, curly, perm helmet hairdos. With, like, really giant Coke bottle glasses tinted and a sweater, but with a turtleneck under it.
Well, you know she's the high school librarian.
Yeah. Oh. And the whole time she was on the phone, there was a cat on her lap.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe two.
There are lots of doilies in your house, Ash.
Do we need to get into this right now?
This is the second show where we're describing your family to you.
To her.
We're sorry. No, we're not.
No,
I'm not sorry.
We're way less sorry.
I just look at the phone realizing that my mom just hung up on me. And I'm like, kind of hurt feelings. And I'm just like, fine. I'm just going to support it. It's like, call me Ashley. And I walk back.
Okay. Walk back and make it to the rest where everyone else is hanging out, rest of the group. What do you guys do?
scanning the crowd for Rick or that blonde dude or...
Make a perception check.
Pardon?
Make a perception check.
Should all of us do it?
If we're all looking.
Yeah,
we're
all
listening
looking.
To the concert.
I'm not looking.
Wah, wah. Nine.
Nope.
Thank you, chat. I am going to use my reroll on that.
Zeke, are you looking at all?
Yeah, I got 14.
A 14? Okay. Yeah.
That's pretty good.
I also have observant, which I told you.
Reggie, what'd you get?
What, me? No, I'm not looking, I'm just watching the show.
Okay. So, that makes sense. Thank you.
14. I got an 8, which is better.
I may or may not have forgotten why we came here. I just am excited that we're at the show.
Fortunately, none of you spot anybody.
But
no, it is pretty busy.
Do we need to get closer?
Yeah, let's get closer.
You could try mingling.
Oh, mingling.
What if we get on the stage?
Oh my god. Are you saying this out loud?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I'm gonna how like is it really full?
Yeah. There's almost like trash cans with fires in them here and there. People are like having a good time. It's like just really inspirational, awesome sax music.
Can I try jumping up on the crowd and crowd surfing to the front?
I don't think this is that kind of crowd.
Damn it.
It's not a rock band.
No.
It's more like 80s inspirational sax music.
I was a little nervous about the fire pits.
Oh, wow. I was definitely picturing a rock band the whole time.
Oh, you were?
Yeah, like the scene in The Lost Boys.
But that was not a rock band.
Yeah, it was. In the 80s, saxophones were part of rock and roll in the 80s.
For sure.
I wouldn't describe it as a rock band.
I feel like it's just a sax concert though, right?
It's like a one-man band.
It's not a one-man band.
Not like at a Kenny G show.
I mean, one really beautiful sax player on stage with the rest of the...
And he's like singing into the microphone and doing sax solos in between. And
I picture it kind of like how Jethro Tull has a flute, but like it's because the singer plays flute every once in a while. Right? Because he's singing and playing saxophone.
Yes. That. Exactly like that. I apologize if I didn't describe it correctly. It's really tight.
So the moral of the story is I can't crowd surf.
Probably not.
Try.
This is kind of killing the vibe.
Yeah, it wouldn't be this. Close, but no dice.
Speak for yourself, I'm getting a whole new vibe.
You're smoking your vibe.
Yeah, Reggie is loving
it. Stone the pad, dude, this is sweet.
What are you
going to
do?
I think I'm going to try and push through the crowd. And get to the front and pop up on the stage.
Okay.
What should we do? I mean, that's crazy. Why are you gonna do that? Do you think you're gonna go to view?
Maybe I could see him from up there.
Maybe we could just do we have to get on stage? Like, are there areas around the stage we could get on?
I mean, there's speakers on the side.
You should.
So big speakers on the side.
Yeah.
If anyone can get away with being on stage, it's gonna be dark out here.
It's pretty dark out here, right?
Yeah.
I'm going close to backstage.
Okay, go for it.
That's it. You're I'm close to backstage.
All right.
Professor, what are you doing?
You guys are making me nervous.
You guys would just notice that Zeke is not there at all anymore.
Wait, you didn't tell us?
No, as a GM, you guys are making me nervous. I'm what are these guys gonna do?
What is the Jazzercise instructor going to do?
Roxy,
what is she going?
She's gonna get on stage. Where'd Zeke go? Do I realize Zeke?
I don't know.
You might see me in the back, just starting to handshake people that are back, just giving some pounds.
Of course you're backstage.
I'm not totally backstage in this game there.
I guess, should we go into the crowd? Oh god.
That's
a lot of people.
This is not my sort of crowd.
This music is perfect. way to kill it, Kiku.
I guess we should try to fit. I'm just gonna follow you.
Yes!
yes!
Where are you? Oh, Mindy follows.
Let's do this.
This is not.
You guys are leaving Reggie behind?
No, Reggie.
Reggie's in the back of the crowd.
I thought Reggie
already,
was in the back getting stoned.
He's just watching and smoking.
Reggie, do you wanna come with us or are you gonna stay here?
Where are you guys going?
We're gonna go to the front.
Go to the front, get a better shot? Sure, yeah.
Yeah, all right, let's go.
Get a better view, I'm down.
All right. As Reggie's passing through the crowd, you see a lot of people hey Reggie, what's up, man?
Yo, what's up?
How's it going, buddy?
What's up, y'all? Hook you up later.
Oh, yeah. Reggie. See lots of fist bumps and high fives. Like, what's up, Reggie? What's up, man? What's good?
I just pass my joint to somebody, forget about it, keep going.
Reggie, ask them if they've seen those guys.
Oh, hey, have you seen those dudes with the leather and the light and all the, those dudes?
That's 30% of the people here, man.
Yeah, okay, but you know that dude with the douchebag with the feathers in his fucking hair?
Oh!
Yeah, those guys. You seen those guys?
Ryan, short dude, got a little man complex.
Yeah, Ryan, yeah, and they're hanging out. Have you seen him or their buddy Dick or whatever?
Honestly,
Rick,
stoned. I wouldn't remember if I did
see him. It's cool, man, me too. All right, we're gonna get a good shot. Good to see you,
dude.
All right,
yeah, have a good time. This guy's amazing.
It was worth a shot.
Sorry, no,
Reggie's friends, probably not
Reggie's
the best people.
You are
very popular.
Sorry,
absolutely
they haven't seen your friend, sorry.
Yeah, we figured that out.
Asking.
Thanks, Reg.
Thank you for asking, Reggie.
Anybody that Reggie passes his blunt to probably isn't the perfect person to ask.
Do you know other people that you wouldn't pass your blunt to?
I mean, there's lots of people I wouldn't pass my blunt to.
Like
cops? Usually teachers, but I feel like you're cool. We could hang out if you want.
I appreciate that, Reggie.
So you're a chemist. Does that mean you can make, stuff?
We'll talk later.
All right, cool.
I think LSD. I don't know. Anyways. Okay, never mind. Let's just keep going.
All right.
All right.
Have we made it to the front of the stage yet?
So as you're walking through,
no.
While we're looking, you to roll for your presence.
Ooh. Thank you. Yes.
So D8, D20.
This one goes well for me, hopefully.
Do you feel awkward at all, Mindy Benton?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mindy Benton feels extremely awkward.
I got a 19.
A 19.
Yeah, I got a lot of presents.
Normally that'd be a good thing, but in this case it's a bad thing.
What?
Yeah, you have a dude out of nowhere just kind of like grab you by the waist and start dancing with you.
Do I see this?
No.
Yeah. He's like grooving with her.
I'm just going to shove him off away.
You can take care of yourself. I'm sorry.
I got it. That's okay.
I was about to like come in and save you.
That's okay.
I start laughing when I see her shove the dude off.
Yeah.
I'm gonna like shove him off and just be like, hey dude, thanks, like, but
care you! You look great!
Cool!
I think my sister's in your jazzercise class! The small town.
Probably, yeah. I teach jazzercise.
And he like gets closer again.
Jeez, and like, I like back off again.
He gets closer again.
Do you know Rick?
He's been drinking.
Yeah, great call. Do you know Rick?
Whoa! Professor! What are you doing here?
He teaches everyone.
Are you in my class?
I'm supposed to be in your class. Oh, that giggle. You're so cute. How's it going? You like to get freaky?
And he gets, dude, back off.
He's very overwhelmed.
From Roxy and starts getting close to you.
Very overwhelmed by this.
He's thrusting.
Have you seen Rick or Ryan?
It's this funky beat. What?
Rick?
Oh, I like your moves.
Have you seen Rick?
Closer and closer to you.
Or Ryan. You are a very pungent man.
He ignores your remark about his pungent nature. And Pet says, who?
Rick?
I know lots of Rick.
Anemic, vitamin D deficient. Very pale. Very pale.
Is that what you're into?
No.
Because you're like a cougar, right?
I am not that much older than they are.
You're a professor, though.
I'm very intelligent.
I like smart girls.
Very underrated.
As he keeps thrusting.
And he's getting closer and closer.
To try and just backing up a little bit while dancing awkwardly.
Your dancing is only encouraging.
I like
you to be honest. No, the GM. Normally I would give those things away, but I feel the need to because I feel bad for you. Yeah.
So then you have not seen Rick or Ryan or their friend.
He's just making eyes at you now.
Okay, I'm gonna go grab Mindy, Professor. I'm gonna go, Professor.
Thank you.
Whoa, where are you taking her? The professor's like totally into me. Professor,
hold that thought, and I will be right back.
He hands you a paper bag.
What's in the paper?
With the bottle.
Mindy takes it.
Professor,
have some. Come on, let's jam.
Mindy opens the bottle. I smell the bottle. What is it? It's alcohol.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We're in the middle of something. Come on, let's go.
Who knows? It smells kind of fruity too, though. Alcohol and fruit. Who knows what's in there?
Exactly. Who knows what's in there, Professor?
It could be Alizé.
I dip a pinky in. Has anybody ever told you not to drink things?
Actually,
the liquid's too far low. Your pinky won't reach it.
One moment, please. And I get a pipette out of my bag. Of course you have that on you.
And dip the pipette into the bottle to extract some of the liquid. Hand the bottle back to him. Put the pipette into
a little... Oh, come on. You gotta have a sip.
I sort of follow the bag as
you
it goes like from her to him.
Save
like,
it for later.
I have to analyze this. Thank you for the sample. Good, I appreciate
try some.
It. I appreciate it.
Try some.
Very much.
You try
hey,
some.
Hey, tell you what. You can dance a little bit with me, have a drink. I hope you find whoever it is you're looking for. Right, Reggie? Sup, Reggie?
Oh, what's
hanging
up?
Out with the professor, too? Apparently, she's a party animal.
She is? Sweet.
Yeah!
Yo, what's in the bag?
Oh, it's my jungle juice, bro. You want some?
Oh, yeah, sure, dude. Oh.
He hands it to you.
Have a swig. Hand it back. Yo, we're looking for my friend's friend or boyfriend or something. Dick or whatever.
Rick.
I don't know about, Rick. No, I don't Rick. Know about Rick. Dick. Boyfriend? Your boyfriend?
No,
you
Rick.
You kind of look like you hate people, though. You sure you got a boyfriend?
Hey, be nice.
Well, we're look at her. Rick. Look at how she's looking at me. I can't. I wouldn't want to.
John, that's just,
like,
that's
honestly,
just how she looks at people. Don't worry about it.
Like my nethers are like kind of shriveling up right now. Mm. Yeah.
Sorry.
But then I see the professor and everything's okay again.
Stop looking at the professor. Ew. Professor, can we go? He's definitely not helpful.
Come on, professor. Oh. Take a drink.
Oh, all right. We'll see you on the
wild side.
Oh, bro. Like pat him on the back. Like, all right, it's time to move on.
Okay. Oh, you guys are... Sorry, Reggie. I didn't know, man. That's cool, though, man. Older women, they're kind of hot sometimes.
Oh, I mean,
All right, buddy. I'll catch you later.
Yeah, later, dude.
He allows you to leave. I would say unmolested, but you were kind of a little molested there.
Please do not allow that I could lose my job.
You could?
She's a teacher.
You're not supposed to have relations with a teacher, Reggie.
We're not?
I am not hearing this. I have to work with these morons. Not you morons, the other morons.
They seem like morons.
I'm so glad I'm not part of this conversation.
Focused.
All right.
We're heading focused
towards the stage, so.
Okay. So you kind of push through the crowd, and you manage to get to the stage where the gentleman is still performing. And there's some speakers and some pyrotechnics and sparks and whatnot all around.
Can you give me a leg up?
Yeah.
I don't even know why I'm asking you. I'll just jump up. Just like climb up real quick.
Jazzercise onto the stage.
Yeah, I've got strong leg muscles.
All right. Can you give me an agility check?
Yeah. Where's my agility?
Ooh.
Your agility is pretty good.
It's pretty good. It's not too bad. I got a 10. Is that enough? Am I gonna need help?
A 10?
Yeah.
Can you use a reroll?
I think I have one of those. Thanks, chat.
Just a second. I need to.
Can't figure out this new thing.
Right, I got 15 this time. And we lost her.
Thanks. That didn't work.
Wait, what'd you get this time?
15.
I need help.
Yeah, grab.
You got 15?
Yes.
Okay, so that succeeds.
Yay!
And you get up onto the stage. And
in the corner, like trying to not like take like be in the very front.
Like, as she jumps, I'm like,
can
whoa!
Can you help me up?
Whoa, yeah. she just jumped onto the stage!
She's very athletic.
Did you know she was gonna do that?
She's gonna
I did not.
Dance! You have to dance or people are gonna
I
think
know
it's
that!
Weird.
I'm already dancing! Of course.
Are you gonna help me up?
Yeah. I'm gonna like do my dance moves and like kinda grab your wrist and try and swing you up.
Good!
Dance!
Wait,
dance!
No, I'm gonna just, you dance, I'll stay in the back.
You have to dance or people are gonna kick you off the stage!
No, I'm just gonna stay they'll not see me.
Dance with me!
No! What? This is not part of the plan! No,
Prof,
it's not happening.
No.
I'm
no.
not.
You're so
no.
sexy!
I'm not.
Just be dancy.
Ash is like trying to go to the back, like, no, I'm just gonna stay.
You need to dance, otherwise
you dance
look
in front
out
of me.
Over the crowd for
I'm
Rick.
Trying to find, you dance, I will sneak behind you and watch and see if anybody we can find out.
Professor, you want to come up and dance?
No.
You sure?
No.
How loudly do you yell, you need to dance?
I'm saying it too.
I mean, as loudly as I can, I guess, because it's a real
show. So over the
show.
Crowd?
Yeah.
So the people next to Reggie start to be like, woo! Because they think you guys are totally drunk. And they're like cheering you on.
Act wasted.
I'm so.
Security
no, dance,
comes and
dance.
Security comes and escorts Ashley off stage.
They just leave me.
Yeah, they leave you up there.
Oh, great. Have I spotted anything
but, like,
yet?
Anybody
been here for a while.
while during the dancing.
Did I see anybody when I was up there?
No, security came pretty quickly. You're bad for business. I observed your moves. She passed, you did not. It was a GM choice.
I was trying to hide in the shadows. I was hiding in the shadows.
Yeah, you failed.
So I'm still dancing?
Yeah, and Saxman takes notice of you and beckons you to come on over center stage. He's like doing his little...
And I'm like shimmying with him.
Yeah. I still believe. He's like doing his thing.
I'm kind of into it though. Like,
yeah.
It's kind of hot.
So are you looking at... And he's like back to back with you and you're both jamming and crowd's going crazy.
And I'm looking out over the crowd still.
Okay.
Like I'm looking for Rick, but like I'm actually getting really into it and kind of forgetting what I'm doing.
Yeah.
I'm like kind of
There's
really
a lot
this.
Of people.
Yeah. It's pretty fun.
It's packed. So you'll have to roll for perception and hope that you roll pretty high.
We have so many perception. Thank you.
D4.
Yes.
So when I'm with security in the back, do I see anything back there? Is there anything like, do I see perhaps a certain friend?
We had a 19.
That might be able to.
19,
yeah. A 19. Uh-huh. Okay, so while you're looking around, you do catch a glimpse around one of the fire barrels, sort of like sort of by the ocean side, because one side is sort of near the boardwalk, mm-hmm. the other side is over by the ocean. A group of gentlemen with their bikes parked on the beach.
Oh, perfect. Okay, I'm gonna like dance for like until the end of the song, and then I'm gonna kiss the sax player on the cheek, and then jump off the stage into the crowd.
Okay, go for it. Can you do an agility check?
I can. Please tell me I don't like land on someone. I'm going to reroll. That was no bueno. Someone's gonna die.
I can't change the reroll or I can't adjust the numbers on my end. So
right.
I need someone else to subtract them there.
We're using our bracelets.
Yeah. It's just normally I can subtract them from that screen you guys are looking at, and it's not working right now.
15.
15?
Yeah.
Okay, so you land unmolested. You didn't land on a dude, thankfully.
Thank God.
And you manage to sort of collect yourself, and you notice your friends are off to the side, and poor Ashley is being held by security now.
Do I see anybody backstage that might be able to help me? Do I see Zeke?
You see Zeke, but it's up to Zeke if he wants to help
you out.
Man, you're not allowed on stage.
I know him.
You're not allowed on the, you know him.
Hey,
I know Zeke.
Big Mike.
Come on.
Big Mike.
Sup,
bro?
How's it going, fam?
Hello. She's with me.
Yeah.
She's with you?
Yeah, it's like...
Why does everyone seem so surprised by this?
It's like a new rehabilitation, you know, the crossing lines, you know, Ebony and Ivory thing. Trying to teach, you know, white girls how to get down.
You're gonna have to spend some time on that one. I got her up on stage. It was bad. People were starting to leave.
Big Mike. What's my real name? Isn't it Charity? Zeke Charity.
All right, man. I
got
you.
Wait. I got something for you.
Sup?
Kumo D.
What? Thanks, man. You have a good time here, and good luck with the ivory. Right now, she's looking less like ivory and more like white out.
Ivory's
precious.
What does he want to say? We are the world?
We are, man.
One love, man.
One love.
That's on the Lakers.
I wasn't going to let her go, but you sold it.
That was
He lets you go. No getting on stage anymore, all right?
I didn't want to be up there.
No getting on stage, all right?
Okay. Ash.
Unhands you.
What's wrong with everybody?
Ridiculous. You gotta chill.
I'm chill. This is ridiculous.
Breathe out.
I'm gonna walk over and join them. Like, get through the crowd and be like, hey guys,
we're gonna pass
the motorcycle.
Reggie and Mindy before you see them.
Oh, okay, perfect.
All right, Roxy, good moves up there.
Thanks.
Roxy,
that was fun.
Are you injured?
Injured why?
You jumped off of the stage.
It's not that high.
How high is the stage?
It was pretty high. She rolled really well.
It's called a stage dive. It's a thing.
Stage.
I'm pretty good at
dive.
I was a cheerleader. I know how to like tumble and shit. It's fine.
You were a cheerleader.
Don't ask questions.
No. I'm not disrespect.
Are we with them now?
I don't think.
Oh,
okay. Cool.
All right. Oh, we made it.
I saw the motorcycles over like near the beach, and I think that that's maybe where the guys are hanging out. I couldn't really see the people that well, but
okay,
like
we
I saw.
Go.
Yeah, that's okay. What I'm saying.
Let's go. I'm so over this, like, whatever this is.
This was fun.
This
what
was
are
terrible.
You talking about? I love
this was
that.
Awful. Wait,
but the show's not over.
Reggie, we're not here
Reggie,
for the show.
We have a mission.
Oh, that's right, your sister!
Yeah, Alex.
Yeah.
For some reason that I'm hanging out
yeah,
with you
God,
guys
I hope
right
she's
now.
Okay.
Yeah. Me too.
This was a very, very overstimulating experience.
All right.
Are you.
Let's
go. Do you need to calm down? Because I can help you out.
No, I'm okay.
All right, let me,
I don't think she's supposed to smoke. She's a professor.
She's a professor. Reggie.
Maybe later.
Oh, trust me. Professor
Smoke. Professor
Smoke. I sell to like three different of my teachers.
Oh God, okay, like I shouldn't know that.
Don't tell me which ones, I don't wanna know.
You never
actually
sold
kinda
to my
do.
Actually I kinda do.
Did you sell to high school?
Your sister, let's go.
Yes, good call.
What, no, I wasn't selling in high school.
Oh, okay.
And as you're walking, you see like a lady in a leather jacket with her hair pulled back, wearing a cross earring.
No way.
She kind of pushes past you guys and kind of gives you a little bit the side eye and like is dressed sort of in what you would consider the uniform of these biker thugs.
Let's follow her.
She pushes
Wait.
Back you guys.
I'm down to follow her.
She guys back and
like she's trying to block us?
No, she's just like pushing her way through the crowd.
Oh,
she's just a lot less gentle about it than you
well,
guys are.
I'm gonna follow like right in her path, like where the people have separated.
Is she going towards the motorcycles?
On. Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah. Oh. We'll follow as well.
So she's like pushing through and can I have you roll? Are you in the front?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I have you roll for stealth?
For what?
For stealth. So it'd be, I'm going to say agility.
We'll go with agility. Okay.
Not deception.
Getting a lot of agility rolls today.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. Like it a lot.
Ooh.
Oh, I don't like that.
You roll that. I think my rolling rubbed off on you.
Yeah, I don't think I get to sit next to her anymore.
Okay,
never mind.
I don't understand
14.
Why I can't do it.
14?
Yeah.
Okay, so she does notice you. And she kind of like turns around. And as you're walking, as she sees you coming through the crowd behind her, tips over one of the fire barrels in your way and continues walking a little bit
what
quicker.
What a beezy. Okay.
Not rad.
Not rad.
Not rad. Cause that coming out of your mouth is funny. So you guys kind of start to lose her a little bit in the crowd as you help the startled people around. Kind
but of we know like the general direction of the bike.
Yeah.
So
yeah, you do.
She's just slowing us down.
Mm-hmm.
That means we're on to something.
That's not nice.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
This is
sure.
a fire hazard.
Do you have? Do you want to put it out? We can use sand. To put
are
it
you,
out.
Are you worried yeah. about the sand catching fire?
No.
No, I think she's worried about the people.
No.
That'll be fine. It's a bonfire. Look, the fire's on the sand. It's a beach.
I'm gonna see, keep like.
Yeah,
going
I'm gonna
right
go with
yeah.
her and keep walking.
Okay.
I think we all are. Yeah.
So as you follow her in her general path, you come across a group of these guys, kind of chilling,
gosh.
Drinking, smoking.
I just got nervous.
Their bikes are parked on a line.
How many?
12.
Oh no.
Mm-hmm.
Is Rick there?
Huh?
Is Rick there?
Oh yeah. They're all there. And they're chilling and they're eating Chinese food and like hanging out. And they're all wearing leather jackets. They all have like different accessories and feathers in their hair. And
I'm feeling really sheepish.
And they're all inexplicably just kind of intimidating and gorgeous.
God damn it. So I like look at Roxy and I'm like, okay, so like. I'm not, like, we're not that close. Like,
it's okay.
He's gonna be really weirded out.
At least
I think.
He knows who you are.
I don't think he does.
Where are you
I
guys
think...
standing?
We're, like, right on the edge of the crowd where they can't see us?
Yeah. Yeah. Totally where they can't see us.
We completely blend in. We are
Uh-oh.
A very
yeah,
blend in sort of group.
Oh, no.
You know,
Uh-oh.
Like,
fam,
I feel like
you need
this
to think
a,
this through.
This is a good camouflage.
Yes.
This is just talking in the corner.
All talking in the
and
corner.
And the gog, like, I feel like I really, like, just this is my crowd.
Did
they
that go well
you.
For us?
They see you.
Damn.
Do they don't do anything yet.
I'm gonna just go and shove her towards them. And because I noticed them like looking at
edge of this like circle with them sitting, kind of hanging out. You see the girl that you were following.
Before she shoves her out, Mindy grabs I grab a vial from my purse and shove it into Ash's hand and put it in your pocket. If you are in trouble, just break it on the ground and away from you.
Oh, okay.
Very, very big trouble.
Okay.
Go.
Okay.
You can do this.
If you need help, like, scream or something.
The edge of this, like, because they're all kind of, like, sitting in, like, a circular type of shape and chilling and standing by the bonfire is the female that you guys were following earlier. And she's, like, drinking out of a paper bag and she sees you and looks you up and down. What do you want?
Hey, I was just hoping to talk to Rick real quick. Just...
Okay, whatever. Rick! Is she one of yours?
Oh.
And Rick kind of just like looks over and he's like motions for you to come over.
Ooh. I go over.
Yeah. Rick is chilling. He's sitting there eating Chinese food and being really inexplicably cool about his eating Chinese food. They're cool guys.
I'm like super intimidated and embarrassed and like awkwardly go over.
How'd you find me?
Hey, it doesn't matter.
What are you doing here?
Can I just ask, do you mind if I can, like, ask you a few questions?
Did you follow us?
No, we just put pieces together where you were.
It's a little strange, but okay.
Can I just ask you, I mean, do you mind if we, like, walk a few steps away? Is that okay? There's a lot of people here, and it's just kind of it's just a little awkward for me.
Well, if you could say in front of me, you could say in front of them, right, guys? And they all kind of chuckle and laugh.
Really? You can't walk two steps?
Well, I could, but I don't really want to.
Wow.
And you like to.
You guys can't hear this.
No, I'm just judging the OC.
I am judging myself as well.
I'm still trying to figure out why you're here.
Because I just need to ask you a couple questions, man. It's not a big deal.
Questions about what?
Well, last time when you were acting super interested about talking to me, apparently.
Last time I was asking questions, kitten.
Yeah. And?
You just don't seem the type to hang out at a place like this. I guess maybe that's why I liked you.
Okay.
Definitely don't seem the type to be forward enough to follow me.
Okay.
Show up out of the middle of nowhere, being extra inquisitive, asking me for one-on-one time.
Well, I mean, if you wanted one-on-one time, I wouldn't mind. But that's neither here nor there. Last time I talked to you, there was a little annoying kid that was trying to, I don't know what she was doing. I'm wondering have you seen her, if anybody that you hang out with has seen her? She's missing.
And why would you think I would know?
Because you seem to be around a lot of places.
That kid seemed to be more into you than she was into me.
I didn't say the kid was into you.
No, I just meant in general. She seemed incredibly interested in you, in particular.
She, yeah, very much so. Yeah. Stories, yes. Which I can't talk about. But the thing is that you're one of the people that saw her last, and you hang out at night a lot, and she went missing a lot at night, so I was just, you might have seen something.
I didn't.
Trying to see if I can use something.
You could.
I'm gonna, can I use demoralize on him?
You can attempt to.
I'd like to attempt to, and I'm going to use one of my... Oh, and I'm so close to getting a seance. I really want my seance.
Devil bunny.
I'm
going to use one of mine.
What?
I'm going to activate my sunglasses at night.
Okay, well, while you're doing that, I'm going to I'm going to try to use demoralize.
It's like the full getup.
Oh, I hate you right now. You look so good. Okay, I'm going to use demoralize. to try to get him to like actually give me some information. So I need to roll d20 plus d10. Ooh, 16.
16.
Nice.
So,
which means, what does that mean? My level.
Yeah, you should probably read out the bane for
so,
everyone.
So, when I demoralize, I cause my enemies to doubt themselves. And I am at power level 3. So, it's a disadvantage of 1.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it works.
Okay.
Do you want to read out what it does? Just for our audience.
Yeah, so disadvantage. You have a disadvantage on all action rolls, and it will cause my enemies to doubt themselves. So I'm going to make him doubt his, like, smoothness mm-hmm. and if he is lying to me or not.
Okay. You see him kind of, like, shift a little bit. You see the crowd kind of, like, look at you. His cronies. And he's like, told you to know anything about her.
Listen, I know... I happen to know that she has had multiple interactions with you. What's that about?
She's never talked to me before.
Interesting. Evidence would suggest otherwise.
What evidence?
Evidence? I don't carry it with me. I'm not stupid.
If he's saying she didn't talk to him, he's saying she didn't talk to him. And suddenly you hear Raven behind you, standing in her steel-toed boots, a couple inches taller than you. When you turn around, your head comes up to maybe her nose.
Okay, so, wait, my head goes up to her nose?
Yeah, she's tall.
Oh, man, because I'm tall.
Yeah. Hey, Raven, calm down. She's just like...
So maybe you didn't talk to her, but maybe you've seen her, or you know somebody that might have seen her last.
She just kind of like puts a finger on your chest and makes you step back a couple of inches from her, and she's just like, maybe you should run along to your friends, kitten. This is not a great place for you to be.
Says who?
Says me.
Okay, and what are you gonna do about it?
Do you really want to find out?
This isn't looking good.
Are you getting?
You're trying to make eye contact with someone in mirrored sunglasses right now.
It's really hard.
We can't hear, right? But we can just like see the physical body language. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Should we, like...
I'm gonna start walking forward.
How does it look to us? It just look like two people talking to her, like...
Raven's back is to you.
Somebody wants
Okay, so we can't, like, see the push.
No.
Somebody wants to let me get that seance. Can I try to make her doubt herself as well?
I don't think it would. To be honest, it wouldn't help.
Okay.
Especially not
like listen, Raven... there's a little kid missing. I don't see what the big deal is of trying to help somebody try to find it. It's Roxy's little sister. I mean,
The big deal is that Rick told you he doesn't know anything, so take a hike.
Well, maybe somebody else here does.
Even if they did, why would they tell you?
Why wouldn't they? That's really weird. She's a little kid.
Listen, there are forces here that are outside the comprehension of your little world. Take a hike.
You don't scare me.
From behind you, you hear Rick say, come on, Raven. It's fine. She's just like, really, Rick? This? I get you get around a little bit.
Ooh.
But this?
So
I'm sorry, Tara. I feel bad.
I don't even care. My heart is black.
Say that out loud. Please tell me you say it out loud.
I'm sure I say it out loud.
If you want to ride with us, it's going to need to be a lot blacker than that.
I don't care if you think I'm attractive enough to talk to you.
It's not about being attractive. It just takes a certain type of person to kick it with us, okay? Now, listen, if all you did was come here to ask about this kid that Rick just told you he knows nothing about, then maybe it's time for you to go.
You know, the problem is I feel like you guys aren't telling the whole truth.
Maybe we aren't.
So that's kind of weird to me. Why would you hide information of a missing child?
You suddenly see the short guy pop up out of nowhere.
Ugh. Hey, Shorty.
Ryan, do you say that to him?
No.
He's just like, so you did make your way out here.
Hmm.
Sorry, guys, this one's on me. And I'll just kind of like chuckle and look at him. And Rick says, ugh. I'm over this party. You see him kind of get up. And he tosses his, like, Chinese food on the ground, so do the rest of them, and Raven, like, giving you one last, like, kind of crooked smile, like, kind of backs up and goes over to her own motorcycle with her, like, fringe leather jacket and hops onto it. And they all start to leave.
I pull the vial out and I throw it at them.
Oh, no!
No!
What vial did you give her?
I gave her persistent damage.
So I'm going to have you go for it.
Yeah, so I gave her a firebomb, essentially. That's my energy versus their guard.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And what's the radius on it?
And as I yell it or throw it?
Setting a target ablaze.
As I throw it.
So it's one person.
Yes.
I throw it at Raven.
Oh, my God.
And I'm like...
I rolled a 23.
Oh, damn, whoa. Get it, girl.
Oh, no.
Oh, wait, it's a 16. I'm sorry. So 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. I rolled a 21 versus her guard. And then at the beginning of target's turn, before they take any action, the target suffers damage determined by the power level of the bane, and I'll roll that. It's a level 2. And the damage automatically bypasses the afflicted character's defenses, but it can be reduced by any resistance to damage of a certain type, and it's fire type.
Okay.
Energy. And then it does, we have to do checks and more damage per round.
Okay.
So I throw it at Raven and I say, I yell at her, kitten wants to play.
Oh, God.
I also have my seance.
Okay. Oh, you have your seance?
Yeah.
Oh, snap.
So, and as I see that vial being thrown, I'm going to pull my full Fonda out.
Yeah, I'll do that. So
a little nervous now. What,
do we see them just sort of all get up and walk away nonchalantly, and then her just fucking throw shit?
Yes. I told you, big trouble, big trouble.
This is big trouble. I know they're lying to me. And she called
Does
me
no
Kim.
One have any chill at all?
Nope. No chill.
I have been doing nothing but chilling this entire time.
I mean, the biker gang had a lot of chill, but...
That's true.
Not anymore.
Except for Ryan. Ryan really didn't have any chill at all.
Oh, wow. The music started to get action-y.
Mm-hmm.
So,
let's get physical music.
Vial gets thrown. Kitten wants to play. Seance.
Okay. Oh, so it does hit her, and you hear her let out like kind of like a shriek as she pulls her leather jacket up, and she is wearing leather. It doesn't catch on fire, but she does take some damage, and immediately you see like two of her friends from her group kind of like cover her up or like stand in front of her and kind of obscure her from view in a strange way.
Huh.
And immediately you see Rick twirl around in his very attractive way that he does with his very voluminous hair. He says, whoa, what was that? What are you trying to do here?
I'm trying to get information.
So your idea is to attack Raven?
And seeing her having thrown my firebomb. Mindy is like, oh my goodness, it starts going forward towards the
group. I also run up.
I'm
going to
fall as well. Yeah. We'll say, did you give her a fucking grenade in a bottle? What was that?
And you see like Ryan get in front with his little short man complex and he says, hey, what's your problem? And he gives you a push. He's like, do you want trouble? You and Rick is really cool the whole time. He's like, calm down, Ryan. Clearly we've riled up the girl.
We don't want trouble. We have a question. Did you answer it? Ask them?
Are these guys with you?
With me?
No, I'm talking to her.
It's her sister that's missing.
Alex. Remember Rick? Alex?
Yeah, I remember Alex. Of course I remember.
The girl, I can have I have something that could help. Oh my God. Is she all right? I rolled a 4 on my damage, by the way.
Okay. She's okay.
Oh my God.
Can't see her though.
If you would just let me ask, I could perhaps help her.
Yeah, I mean, shouldn't she be like stop, drop, and rolling right now?
Is it their medical attention?
Although she let out a shriek, you notice that as these guys, two guys pass away, she like just kind of wipes her face off a little bit. She has her sunglasses on now, even though it's the middle of the night. And she looks completely unharmed. But you know what you heard. And she's just like, watch it, punk.
Didn't you just set her on fire?
Don't remind her.
And she like gets off the bike and sort of comes and stands next to Rick. She's like, what's it gonna be, Rick? Her or us?
Whoa, 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 what's going on here? I thought we were just looking for information, all right? No one needs to be mad at each other. Did you ask your questions? Have they seen Alex?
They're not really being very helpful.
Have you guys seen the kid?
We already answered her stupid little questions.
Are they answered?
Kitten wants to play, huh? That's the best you could come up with.
You didn't get any information?
They have.
Are we just gonna assault everybody? Your sister stalked? Until we find, like, this.
Come on. Stalked? And you hear Rick say, like, come to think of it, I did see that little twerp around a lot.
Yeah, I think she just really liked you.
We listened. We told her. I never talked to the kid, all right? I had no relationship with her. What do you want?
Are you sure?
Pretty sure. I'd remember. A conversation with her would be pretty memorable, don't you think?
Listen, I'm sorry. My bad.
You're sorry? And you see Raven stand up in front of me. She's like, you're sorry, huh?
You seem fine.
This doesn't excuse you sucker punching me.
She didn't know it was... Didn't know that.
It's fine. No, I didn't know it was in it. I had no idea. But it's fine. Sorry.
I'm telling you, it's not fine.
Okay.
Whoa, calm down, Top Gun, all right? Just don't worry, all right? We're just trying to help somebody out. No one needs to get angry at anybody.
But I'm telling you, we got a problem.
It's fine.
Rick, can you just tell me the last time you saw Alex?
Saw her at the school. She was there. She should be able to tell you.
When?
What was it? Yesterday?
Yeah, yesterday.
Okay.
Listen, if you guys see her or know anything, it'd be great if you let Roxy know. She's really worried. There's some really weird...
She's just a kid.
There's some really weird...
Sure, Roxy. We'll let you know.
Really weird shit around her disappearance.
Right. And some really weird shit's gonna happen to you if you don't take a hike.
I think we should take their cue and just get out of here. There's no reason to fight right now.
Well,
I think we have plenty of reason to.
Oh, God. So cute up.
While this is all... While this conversation is happening, I'm... looking across the bikers and trying to determine, and let me know if I have to roll perception, if there is rampant possible anemia and vitamin D deficiency among them.
They're visibly pale.
Like unusually?
A little, one could say that.
Do you still have that garlic?
Wait, I have the garlic?
I don't know.
No, he just has the herb.
Does Alex like garlic? Yeah, so.
Let me look in my bag. She doesn't wanna have this conversation in front of scary sunglasses at night, man. We should go.
We're missing the show.
You should go. And Raven takes one last look at Ashley and she says, be careful. You don't want to fall down the rabbit hole, Alice.
Her name is Ashley, actually.
Goddamn, Scott. give me, please.
Totally ruined my moment. God!
You love us and you know it.
She like looks over and she's just like. And she gets back on her bike, gives it a good kick, engine starts up.
Well, that was useless.
They know something.
They're
being like super sketchy, secretive. They know something.
Are they like actively leaving? We can have a private conversation?
Yeah, they're getting on their bikes, getting ready to go.
Hey, Roxy, can I borrow your keys really quick?
Keys?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. I'm gonna pull them out of my fanny pack, toss them through.
I'm gonna grab him and immediately start running, booking it towards our car to pull it out.
Okay, yeah.
You guys keep talking, I'll be right back.
I do not
believe I am going to say this. I am beginning to wonder if it is not them who knows something, but your sister.
I don't know why we thought they knew anything anyway.
No.
I thought this was just one big long way for you guys to hit on that dude.
No, I like so over him. Who cares about Rick?
Yeah,
he's like not even that handsome. Like, whatever.
That should not be.
So your sister stalked this dude and he doesn't know where she is.
No, but like they definitely know something.
Why?
They were being super sketchy about it.
They seem sketchy.
And then they're like, they even said, if they knew something, they wouldn't tell me.
Look.
Like, who says that about a missing kid? Like,
it's pretty.
Like, I know I was saying I want extra credit and stuff, but I was gonna help you. Like, it's sad. It's super sad.
I don't know. Like, it just seems like you're projecting a lot on these people.
No. I don't think so. I hang out.
Did Zeke go?
Oh, he's.
I don't know. He borrowed the car for a minute.
Does he see on the sand? This sand is blowing up as I'm driving. Do a little figure eight. Hop on in.
So are you skidding up in front of us?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yes. We should go. Yes.
Whoa.
Do you have a driver's license?
Sort of.
Okay.
Getting in the car.
Yeah, that's good.
Look, I've seen Beverly Hills Cop and Brooklyn Nights.
What does that even mean?
Me too.
Please do.
What do you mean? You haven't seen Beverly Hills Cop?
I
like the funniest movie.
I'm going to floor it and begin trying to see if I can start tailing them. And as soon as I see one, I'm going to kill the lights.
So you kill the lights and you're following them.
What are we doing?
They eventually like drive off the beach and up onto the road. And they're pretty easy to make out. A few of them have like these really long, almost kind of like wire rods off the back of their backs with like these little different colored flags hanging off. And they all have like black bikes, except for Roxy. Hers is bright red. I'm sorry, not Roxy, Raven. I'm gonna get all the names messed up now.
Too many
eyes. Sorry.
I don't
know. And they're all riding down, hooting and hollering. Some of them have like their little pets or whatever on the back of their bikes, whatever you want to call them. And suddenly, as you're driving, you see headlights behind you.
What?
Oh, shit.
I'm gonna look behind it. Is this normal headlights or is it like police?
From what you can see, it's just two headlights in the dark.
Two bikes? Do they look like motorcycle headlights?
They're equidistant apart. Could be headlights from a car, could be headlights from two bikes.
Are we still in like city right now, or is it being more like country roads?
You've been driving often. Long enough, and the weird direction you've been driving is more like, because you've been staying along the coast more, it's become almost like more hill, like cliff-like.
Is there any place I can like turn in to hide the car while this one drives up?
I don't think we're hidden anymore, dude. Those lights are looking at us.
Like, maybe it's not the motorcycle people. Maybe there's someone just like...
I don't know if they're good or bad, but I can tell you the people in front of us now know that we're here. Because we're blocking a bunch of lights.
We can play two ways. I can speed up or slow down.
Oh, God.
Speed up.
Why are we following them?
I don't know. I'm not convinced they know anything. What if they don't know anything?
Do you guys really think they know nothing?
No, they know something. I know they do. Zeke, I'm with you.
Okay.
I don't think we have.
Let's speed up.
All right, I'm gonna start speeding up and see if the taillights actually match speeds with me.
They do.
Ah, shoot.
Are we just gonna keep following? I think we just need to keep following them. Like, maybe they'll lead us to, like, wherever they hang out.
I'm gonna keep going, like, just matching speeds until there's a wide enough way that I can actually do, like, a U-turn. Or is it, does the trail remain narrow the entire time? Are we like really
boxed? It's not too narrow.
I really, really want to do 180 and see who's following us.
Do it.
Oh my god, I'm going to die.
We're fine. Zeke, I have faith in you. Go for it.
This is a really solid
time. As she says that, e-brake on, turn around, full movie spin around.
All right, can I have you roll for agility?
Hell yeah.
Oh my
god. Do you have rerolls?
Oh.
You have three.
I'm gonna re-roll.
Yeah. Woo! Thank you, chat!
Thank you so much!
I would like to not die!
Alright, that's a 13.
Oh gosh.
A 13.
Yeah.
So So as you hit the e-brake and spin, and you know, try to spin around, you do manage to pull a 180, but your car kind of starts to cant a little bit off the road, and it hits the partition, or sorry, the guardrail on the side of the road.
Sorry.
And comes to a stop.
My poor car!
Whoa, that was crazy.
As the motorcycles get a little bit further away from you.
What were you doing? We need to follow them.
Just 1 second.
I'm gonna have, can I get everyone in the car, your, it's not called evasion now, the name of that stat.
It is evasion.
Evasion?
Guard.
Huh?
This isn't a guard now?
Guard, thank you.
Wait, where's your guard?
It's so, evasion and our sheets.
Yeah, so
it's evasion on our sheets.
I'll need to know your guard values.
Got
12.
It.
15.
13. 14. Oh, sorry.
13.
Okay, so now if you take damage.
Yes.
And suddenly the two lights behind that were behind you come racing even quicker up to you, and off jumps this sort of scrawny looking kid with a red bandana on, and another kid with a camouflage shirt wearing dog tags, and you recognize them to be the older and younger Frog.
Oh. I get out of the car. Frogs!
Hey, what's up, Reggie? Are you guys okay?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, we just did a thing, I guess. But yeah, we.
What are you guys doing? What are you guys doing?
We're
almost, whoa, like that turret. Are you okay?
What are you doing?
What are you guys doing out here?
Why were you tailing us?
And you see the younger Frog pop up, and he's like, "We were tracking the location of some of what you might call Nosferatu."
The biker people? Did we ever figure out where Nosferatu are?
The vampires.
Nosferatu, creatures of the night, bloodsuckers.
You're referring to the biker
gang.
Wait,
Frogs, you know her. Have you seen Alex, your little boss, or whatever?
She's been missing.
Yeah, apparently she was taken last night.
So we were gonna get onto them.
Yeah,
So roped in my older brother here. Yep, I always knew this was true.
You always knew?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
We gotta go.
So do you think the bikers have Alex?
Empirical evidence.
Yeah, pretty sure.
Hop on in.
We gotta go. Let's do this.
Good call.
We're like losing time and speed. And
how many people are fitting into this clown car?
Is it a pipe or are they in the bike or is it actually a motorcycle that they're on?
They have like two mopeds.
All right, you guys follow us.
Why don't they just follow us?
Yeah, all right, just follow us. And I'm gonna try to back up in a sensible manner, turn around, and then start flooring it to try to catch up.
Guys, I don't think you're ready for this.
I don't drive anymore.
Judging by your driving skills and how sloppy you've been about this whole thing, I think you guys should stay behind.
We got
leave
sloppy.
It to us. The frogs are on the case. Get your sister back, Roxy.
We need to find her.
We got it. Just trust us.
You guys kind of seem like you're just messing around.
We're not. We take this very.
I mean, you saw it.
I think they might. Oh, I hate saying this. I think they might be right about.
You really think they're vampires?
Do you know what an incredible statistical anomaly it is to have so much anemia in such a small area?
They're just really pale.
You guys, your little sister was stalking this dude. They were part of her little club. They're stalking him, too. Of course they think he's to blame.
At the very least,
We're all just operating on some pictures your sister took, including these kids.
Hey,
wait, do you guys have more evidence?
That's exactly what it is. Evidence.
Evidence of his existence?
We're still compiling evidence at this time. Ma'am.
We're losing time.
Don't worry. We're on the case.
Do you know where these guys hang out? Like, do we actually need to follow them right now? Or, like, can we just go to their house?
We'll find out, though.
I would like to collect a sample.
Well, why don't we just get back in the car and follow them?
Yeah.
You guys are cramping our style a little bit.
Guys, by all means, go ahead.
Especially with your ghetto wagon there.
Okay, you guys go in front and we'll follow you. My wagon isn't ghetto, by the way.
I think you should just leave this to the professionals.
How old are you, like 12?
My age is irrelevant right now. Also, I am 15.
Oh, yeah, fine.
We're like super older than you.
Yeah, I'm a very mature adult.
Yeah,
and you're
not my older brother's here is my chaperone. Yep, let me tell you, I am a vampire hunter extraordinaire.
These kids are crazy.
How old are you?
His older brother is 19, 20.
Oh, so he's older than me.
Fine. Can we, I mean, we gotta hurry.
We are losing the specimens, let's go.
Yeah, we're following you guys,
get in the
sorry.
Car.
So go, Brett, we're gonna follow
so
you.
So they speed off on their mopeds. And you follow them?
Oh yeah.
Okay. So you follow them for about 15 minutes. And they come to a stop on a random side of the road. And as you guys get out of the car to see what the holdup is, the younger frog looks at you guys a little bit perplexed. He's like, I lost him.
What the hell?
I mean, it's not their fault. We're the
These
ones
These mopeds that... don't go that fast.
Yeah, that's why I said you should let us go in front. Come on, guys. We really need to find my sister.
Okay, we're gonna go ahead. We'll scout out.
Do you have any idea where they're heading?
I honestly haven't seen their taillights in like 4 miles.
Oh my gosh.
Do you have a map or anything of this area?
Is there a
Maybe
map?
In my glove compartment.
I'm gonna check that, see if there's like any sort of side roads or anything that's around here other than the, you know, the cliff sides.
The ways in which we take cell phones for granted.
Yeah, I'm gonna probably get out of the car for this and pull it on the hood.
Okay.
Flashlight. Do I need to roll anything for this?
Roll for input.
I would say, like, maybe your logic.
Roll for logic. Okay. 18.
18. You know from looking at the map and from what the frogs have told you when they last saw the taillights, statistically speaking, you have no idea of where they could have turned off.
Great.
Maybe following the frogs wasn't the wisest choice. Also, maybe doing a 180 to
I'm catch regretting the frogs that choice by the second.
I mean, it was cool though.
Maybe we should go back and look more about into what Alex was up to and what she was doing instead of obsessing about this one guy who the girls want to bang.
Whoa. Like, so don't want to bang him?
Do yeah, you still sure. have her book? Is that still in the vicinity?
It's in the treehouse.
Did
tree
we take house. That with us? Or?
Yeah, didn't we grab it?
Did we keep it?
You left it in the treehouse.
Yeah, we left it in the treehouse.
Bummer.
Okay. Well, like, maybe we should go back
like
to the
Like, we haven't, like, looked at her bedroom? That might be a good place, where she was taken, the scene of the crime.
True. There could be... Have
Stoner
the police...
Stoner has ideas.
Have the
you didn't
police
look
been,
at her bedroom?
Been tromping around?
No, I mean, I saw
the police. Come on,
like,
unless we're paying them ourselves, they're not going to do
out.
Anything for us.
No. I am only worried that they would contaminate my scene.
Oh, they definitely did.
Damn.
Why don't Pigs. We... Yeah, it's not a bad idea. We could go back and look at the house.
Paying the police.
I really wanted a blood sample.
It's a little late for that. We lost them.
Yes. Next time I see him in class.
So are we going back to your
house now?
This happens
all the time. We'll be working on it 24/7.
Stealthily.
We'll find him.
Yeah. Frogs, you stay on the dick case.
And we will.
Yeah.
We'll find that dick.
Rick.
Yeah, that guy.
Rick.
We'll find that Rick.
All right, I'm going to take the keys from Zeke because I think it's his fault.
You're not technically wrong, but...
Oh, sweet shotgun. And she gets out and hop in the front seat.
And I'm gonna head back towards our house.
Don't worry,
things.
Guys.
Be careful, amphibians.
We'll be fine. We do this kind of stuff all the time.
Yeah, we can tell you're doing really good at it.
Where do you go?
We're gonna go back to my house.
Okay.
Should we go grab the book first and then go to your house?
That's our house.
No,
it's at the tree house.
Oh, tree houses, yeah.
Yeah, I guess we could
do that.
Let's
go grab the book first and look over it again.
I'm gonna drive to the house with the treehouse was.
Okay. George's house.
Wait. Yeah, we'll just wait in the car. Just go get it.
Isn't the middle of the night?
Yeah, it's fine.
It's okay, I can do it.
She's like super stealthy.
I'm pretty stealthy. So I'm gonna just like tell them to wait in the car. And I'm gonna take the keys with me because Zeke is not doing great in my car.
One accident and your label fly.
Yeah,
what
accident?
This
is the second accident in less than 24 hours that we've all been in.
One of
my
them
poor
wasn't
car
our
is not even gonna run
it's
anymore.
Fine. It's cool.
Anyways, I'm gonna pop. I'm gonna actually open the fence this time since I remember that there's a door. And is the ladder down?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then I'm just gonna like, kind of like, try and be as stealthy as I can and climb up there.
As you climb up, you notice their little sort of hiking lamps. I was going to say hunting lamps. Hiking lamps are, the little Coleman hiking lamps are on.
Upstairs in the treehouse?
Mm-hmm.
That's weird.
And you hear something, but you're not sure what it is.
Oh no. Okay, I'm gonna like keep climbing up the ladder and just like poke my eyes up and like try and see what's going on.
See George in the middle of the room crying.
Oh, George. Okay, I'm gonna like climb all the way up and be like, George, hey!
Oh, hey, Roxy, how's it going?
You know, I'm not that great. I can't find Alex.
Yeah, I know. She didn't come to school today.
Is that why you're bummed?
No, I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm sure she's okay.
Do you have her book?
Yeah, he pulls it out and he hands it to you.
Do you mind if I borrow it?
Yeah, sure. She's your sister. It's her book, so.
Okay, I'm gonna climb all the way up.
I guess you're kind of next to kin, huh?
Yeah. I'm gonna climb all the way up and I'm gonna give him a quick hug. A little pat on the back.
Yeah, no, I'm fine, Roxy. It's okay.
Yeah, no, I know. You're totally fine.
I'm sure she's fine.
Yeah, she'll be fine. We'll find her.
I'm sure she hasn't been taken or anything.
Taken?
By vampires.
So, which vampires are you thinking?
The vampires we were following.
Okay, yeah. The motorcycle gang? The pale one?
Yeah. Yeah.
They're pretty...
I'm sure it wasn't them. It couldn't have been,
right? Have you guys tried the garlic on them?
No, of course not.
Maybe we should garlic them before we... before we determine...
We've never gotten close enough. We don't know a whole lot about them,
vampires.
Right? And there's a lot of them. I mean, it would be pretty stupid to just walk up to all 12 of them and, like...
That's what Alex was doing, right?
That would probably be like the stupidest thing in the world. There's so many of them. You just walk right into the center of them. And, like, yeah. Try to garlic one of them, right?
Alex was doing to Ash.
She's kind of the weak link, the straddler, the sickly gazelle.
Alex?
Yeah. No, Ashley.
I was gonna say, I thought she was your ringleader.
No, Alex was strong. That's why she was smart. There's no way she would just walk up into a circle of 12 of them and try to garlic one of them.
Why do you...
Imagine standing in the middle of, like, 12 of these guys. Oh, man.
Yeah, I get it. Yeah, so weird. I get it. Not a good idea.
Listen, Roxy, I know you don't think vampires exist. Maybe you're right. Tell you what. We get Alex back. I'll stop all the vampire hunting or whatever it is, all right?
Yeah, I think that's what got Alex into this mess.
You're probably right. Hands you the book back.
Okay, George, be safe, okay?
I will.
Why don't you go back into your house and hang out with your parents?
Yeah. All right.
Cool.
Follows you down the ladder.
Okay. I'm gonna, like, pat him on the back, kind of, like, try and push him towards his house and, like, sneak back out. And I'm gonna be like, hey! By the way, don't tell your parents I was here. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, goes without saying.
Cool, dude. And I'm gonna go back to the car. Hop into the driver's seat. Got the book.
All right, let's go to your house.
Lego.
I've been mixing chemicals in the back seat.
I'm sleeping in the front seat.
Can you pass it back to me?
Sure.
I'm gonna just start flipping through the book while with a flash.
Looking over your shoulder.
Is there anything new while we're like looking that we didn't see last time? I don't know.
Not really. There's just clippings from different magazines and comic books and different pop culture things like that. Movie reviews, vampire movies, stuff like that.
So she hasn't detained any hair samples, fingernail clipping, DNA swabs.
Never got
swabs.
Close enough.
Damn.
Okay, we at your place.
Have we made it to my place yet?
We're cruising along.
Okay. You seeing anything back there?
The book.
Nothing. Comics, movie clips, picture of Rick.
Is he doing anything weird in the photos? Like, why was she taking that?
Yes, he's posing for every single one, yet no one's looking. It's just like, or
Is it at the college?
He's maybe just he's so like naturally debonair.
For the girls.
I don't know.
You do notice they're all kind of blurry.
I just assume that's Alex being a terrible photographer. Mm-hmm. Oh, wait a second. Is only he the only thing blurry? Everything else is clear?
Well, the people around him are pretty blurry, too.
Yeah.
Okay. Thought he was like Bigfoot.
Are the people around him his friends?
Yeah.
That's kind of weird.
And what about like backgrounds or bikes that's in the picture or anything like that? Is that all blurry?
Those are a lot clearer.
Do you know if Alex had like a...
Except for Raven. She's crystal clear in every single picture.
Hmm. Really?
Wannabe.
Guys, look at this. And I'm going to start like passing the book around and showing them each picture.
And I'm driving, so I can't see.
Do you wake me up to do this?
I'm going to give you one poke if you don't get up.
Yes. Would you...
Okay. What? Oh, that's right. Okay, what?
Would you like a stimulant?
She's talking about caffeine.
What?
Right?
What caffeine? Kind of... Yeah.
Would you like
yeah,
a
sure.
stimulant?
You're holding.
Wake you up a little. I dig around in my bag, pull out a small purple vial.
Take it. I just grab it and chug it. What happens to me?
It's caffeine.
Okay. I don't notice.
Is it like soda or is it just caffeine?
I don't want to give him a heart attack. Okay. It is slightly larger concentration. I've been working on something. You know, it's fine.
Thanks, I think. Anyway, what's up with this picture?
Look at everyone and then look at this girl right here. That's the one that was like giving Ash a hard time.
Yeah, that girl.
Yeah, what
a
about
jerk.
Her? She's
a jerk.
Is it the glasses?
No.
They're cool.
Look at everyone else here.
She's not cool, Reggie.
Her hair's darker than theirs. Is that it?
Look at everyone else. Anything else you notice?
Oh, wait, is that? Oh, that's not just me!
No.
Oh, that actually happened a lot. They're blurry. I thought that was just me. Okay, man.
But her, they're all blurry but her. Yeah.
What does that mean? But they're moving. They're all moving, right? Alex probably is not like a
great photographer.
Yeah,
I guess Raven's
still. We'll show you when you get to the house.
I'm going to be very
does
upset.
Did she take other photos?
Of
maybe we can compare 13-year-olds her
discovered
her, like,
some.
Oh, no, there's a bunch
of phenomenon. No, I mean, like, photos of other things besides them. So we could, like.
Oh, yeah, is there photos of anything else other than the gang or the group in there?
You see some pictures of their bikes.
Are those blurry?
You see some pictures of. Nope. You see some pictures of you.
Am I blurry?
Nope. And a couple of them you are. But they're kind of, they kind of seem to look like.
Look at this one! Ash is blurry in this one!
That's not me. There's no proof.
And you see some other people that kind of hang out around Ash. That would be a part of her sort of clique.
You have a clique?
You have a clique? You have friends?
Do I have friends?
You have a couple.
Yeah, what? I got friends.
The other goth kids.
I like the surprise. We went from surprise to, yeah, absolutely, I have friends.
I got friends. We don't really talk, we just kind of sit at the same table. That's cool.
Okay.
There's an understanding.
Drink coffee and smoke cigarettes.
I don't smoke.
Not me neither. Just pot.
Okay. My parents would kill me. Anyways. Are we at your place yet? It's taking forever.
I don't think she'd kill you. I think she'd probably be like, oh honey.
That's why I wouldn't do it, because it's annoying that they wouldn't be mad. Ugh, worse. They're so understanding.
You can't do anything.
Crazy.
Are we there yet?
You are.
Can I borrow your phone?
Oh my god, didn't you just call your parents?
That was like hours ago.
Fine.
Can I stay the night?
Is it morning yet?
You want to have a sleep?
No.
Well, I mean, like, it's kind of getting late, so I'm just going to...
It's about 10:30 at night. Your mom is nowhere to be found.
Of course.
I'm going to call my parents real quick.
Okay.
I'm just going to let them know that I'm staying the night at Roxy's.
Yeah, the phone's
okay,
in the
honey.
Kitchen.
Okay, Mom. I'll see you later.
All right. I saved you your lasagna. It's in a paper bag in the fridge, okay?
I'll eat it tomorrow. Thank
you. All right, honey. You have a good night.
All right. Thanks, Mom.
Be careful now, Ashley, all right? If you try
Ash.
To do anything with any boys, you just remember to be safe, okay? You don't have to lie to me about that, all right?
I know, Mom. You tell me, like,
okay,
every time.
Bye-bye.
And I just look at that one again.
The hell you live with. where was the child's bedroom? Where was she
upstairs, up the stairs. I'll lead the way. I'm gonna go, like, take them to the door. So, like, I was coming up the stairs and, like, or I was upstairs, my bedroom's upstairs, and I, like, I went and her door handle, this door handle was, like, hot, right? And then, I don't know.
Can here, we go
you
inside?
Can go inside. I don't know what to tell you.
Okay.
Right, so we head in, what do we see when we get into the room?
So you see glass, and you also, like, shattered. And you
on the
also
inside
see,
the window?
Outside. And there's some specs, like, on the windowsill.
Okay, but it looks like it was broken from the inside then.
From the, well, yes, definitely. Okay. And
broken
where
from
you
the
see
inside.
Like the, and where you see the sort of wood lattice work on the window, you almost see it's like punched a little bit outward, like something
outward.
Sucked out.
Interesting.
Well, that's weird.
Really weird.
I mean, we're on the
force,
second floor.
Obviously,
so.
Punched out with great force.
The other side of the doorknob, are there like the kind of markings that you get when you superheat a metal, like after a fire, how it gets kind of like ashy looking?
Like scorched?
Yep.
It looks okay. What about the door surrounding?
Everything else looks normal.
So there's nothing else that looks scorched like that?
Mm-mm. Do you know if she had any other books that she kept about like her
going to start
doings or journals or anything
okay.
like
that?
I don't know. She might have a diary.
I'm gonna look under her
that
bed.
That looked like an investigation book. She kind of seemed like the type that like would diary. Maybe it's under her pillow.
I'm gonna look under her bed. Do I find anything?
You find the diary. It's under
oh,
her
cool.
bed.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That's all I find?
Yeah, you also find some R-rated, you know, comics that you know she's probably not supposed to have. And you also find like one Playboy magazine that she's probably been experimenting with.
I'm gonna take the Playboy and leave the comics because I may or may not have given them to her.
Okay.
Oh yeah, here, there's a diary too. Check this out. I'm gonna sit down and flip open the Playboy.
I'm doing a reading in the middle of the room.
So what's in the diary?
Oh, I handed it to you.
I'm still
holding the Playboy.
I'm gonna start like flipping through it. What do I?
It's just the daily chronicles of her life.
Does she talk about stalking Rick?
She does, and she always speaks in the third person.
Oh my god.
Can you give us an example?
Yeah, I need to hear it.
Can you read some of it out loud?
It's very noir. Today was an interesting day for Alex. As she went about her day, she wondered if today would be the day she would finally find a marvelous breakthrough in her search for the mystical Nosferatu in the boring, sleepy little town of Springfield. In other news, she had finally got to sneak into the rated R movie at the movie theater today. It was pretty great. Alex was pretty pleased with herself. No one second guessed that she was under 18. She also...
I doubt that.
Oh man, there's a new book that she has
She
to
also
read.
Had enough allowance to finally get some popcorn and watch the movie. It was pretty good. The younger frog came by today. He wanted Alex's help in impressing some chick at school. Alex helped him. She's pretty much the best.
I don't know if there's much use.
There goes down another one in the books.
What about yesterday, right before, what's the last entry say?
Yeah, she probably journaled right before bed.
Today was a pretty interesting day for Alex. Some punk stole her bike, so she had to be ferried around by her older sister. She got her revenge, though. She basically whooped all those guys single-handed, got her bike. It was pretty sweet.
She totally remembers this wrong.
She then orchestrated a crazy, insane attempt to abduct one of the Nosferatu. Through Alex's ingenious planning and skillful execution, they were able to successfully do this by slipping a horse tranquilizer into one of her mochas and then tying her up and dragging her into the station wagon. Of the older frog.
Are you reading this out loud?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, good.
Oh, yeah.
That's how that happened.
This is so damn juicy. This is great.
That is not great. That is not good. That is illegal. Again, why am I the only one that thinks that's weird?
Horse tranquilizer.
Okay. I mean,
so are
you
like the only person Coffee Girl doesn't like?
She
besides teachers.
I'm
she
pretty
doesn't
sure
like teachers.
She like spits in my coffee all the time.
And yet you still
how did you even
there?
Get the coffee?
Skip to the end. Skip to the end just
okay.
And with that, Alex had another amazing day. She's pretty sure she's onto something, though. The evidence just isn't adding up right. There's something going on with those weird, strangely attractive motorcycle boys at school. Why are they there? What are their motives? Are they grooming that weird Ashley girl to be their new protege? Who knows? Next, on the next episode of Alex's Adventure.
I love Alex.
I want to watch Alex's Adventure.
Same size channel.
She obviously mid-word. Has like a huge imagination.
Wait, she stopped mid-sentence?
Mid-word.
Oh, she stopped mid-word.
She stopped mid-word? Mm-hmm.
Something happened. What?
Guys, that's weird.
When does she usually write?
Like right before bed.
Well, that's when she was abducted, correct? When you saw the...
And yeah, it was really late. I guess she must have been writing like with a flashlight under her blanket
something. Weird is happening.
I mean, it's not like my mom would ever check on her.
And with that, you suddenly hear the wind pick up around the house, similar to when it did.
Guys, this is what happened last time.
And it starts whooshing, especially sucking in through that strange hole that is now in the window. And whoa. You hear, like, motorcycles outside. Except not 12 of them. You hear 2 of them.
Is it? I want to run downstairs.
And you hear...
Frogs!
And, like, a sultry voice come up towards the window. And you hear her say... Kitten, come out and play it.
Do I hear this or have I already left?
You heard it.
Okay, so I'm gonna stop and be like,
it's a strange haunting voice.
That's not one of the frogs.
No.
That sounds like Top Gun.
This is really weird.
We gotta go talk to
I didn't finish my reading, but
we have to go talk to them.
No.
Yes! Listen to Professor. We should not talk to them.
What's
up with the wind?
How do they
know where you're
going? I know it's weird.
Head like, out the window to see.
Yeah, can we see?
I'm assuming
outside?
How many of them
see
are
Raven,
there?
But who else is there?
See nothing. Do you see a shiny red bike?
Oh, okay. Wait,
parked outside.
Can we see? Because it's too dark. Is that why I can't see?
You just don't see anything.
What?
Oh.
Okay, I am going to use. I'm going to pull out a vial. Who knows where she keeps them
all.
And
do you remember, audience, you can't interact with the show since things might get a little sticky.
I'm going to pull a vial out of my...
You messed with the wrong bitch, Tara.
Out of my bag and start mixing things around until the liquid starts to bubble and turn red and then down it. And use my blindsight boon to give myself heat vision.
Okay.
Then try to, look again out the window and see if I can see the 2 heat vision figures.
You don't really see much. You just see, like, and you see something really swiftly go around the back of the house to the front. And you see another one start towards the back. But it's so quick you can't discern a shape or figure out what it is.
But it's warm?
Or
is
yes.
it kind of, okay.
Barely.
Okay. And one went towards the front, one went towards the back.
Mm-hmm.
There is something very quickly circling the
oh
house.
My God.
What are you?
I'm doing a reading.
Yeah, that's not gonna help us.
No,
right now.
I just it helps calm me. I need to do a reading right now. This is
okay. You keep doing that, and we'll go
really
actually do something.
Do you have garlic in this house? What?
There has to be.
Have any? A biker gang is attacking us. Do you have any guns?
Do you have that big bat from that yesterday?
Yeah, that was cool.
Yeah?
It's still in the car, right?
Don't go outside. Do not go outside.
It doesn't seem very safe.
I wouldn't go outside.
You don't have any, protections?
I keep a baseball bat by my bed.
You guys are worried about the commies? Come on!
I don't know why I didn't bring that upstairs.
Alex
yesterday.
Has to have holy water or something in this, like, in her room. Start.
You really think holy water is what we need?
Reggie. I mean, I'm not gonna... I'm just gonna start looking for stuff that Alex was using on me.
Okay.
Should I do perception?
Roll a perception.
So I'm gonna leave my cards.
While she's doing that, I'm gonna go downstairs and look for garlic.
Okay.
No.
And while you're.
Ooh, ha!
While you're looking for garlic, you hear a slam against the front door and the hinges creak.
Get upstairs!
Okay, upstairs.
I'm gonna grab the bat that was by Roxy's bed, as mentioned, and kind of run down to the bottom of the stairs.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm gonna stand next to him.
This is, in my mind, I'm telling myself this is what is what men do. I'm supposed to do this, but I'm also terrified.
Okay. I rolled a 7.
We see by nothing.
Can
and
I
with
also...
another slam, you suddenly see that the door flies off its hinges, and you see Raven standing there, she kind of like walks very nonchalantly up to you, and with one arm, just like pushes you out of her way and slams you against the wall, pulling you out of any kind of zen-like state you had.
Oh wait, him.
Your head slams against the wall in a very forceful fashion.
All right.
As she walks her way up, she makes her way up the stairs.
Am I like dazed?
Wait.
Not dazed, but you've taken a lot of damage.
Okay. All right.
So she's alone? Is she armed at all?
She's armed with nothing that you can see.
Okay.
I would
Do
also-
Do we hear her coming up?
Like start searching the room?
She's not trying to hide.
Frantically? For whatever supplies, vampire hunting supplies.
I would the like lights to, start to flicker.
I would like to invoke 20. My...
Yeah, okay. So you're invoking your seance?
Yeah, but if you remember, I don't actually know that I can do this.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I rolled a 20 on the perception.
Woo!
What? Good, girl.
What were you looking for?
I was looking for... Oh, not a natural 20. Just a 20 combined.
I thought your dice... This is for exploding dice only, Lizzie!
No, it would have been great, though.
That would have been nice.
So, I was looking for her vampire hunting supplies, specifically since I don't know if a holy water is actually a holy water. Like, things like garlic, things like steaks, things like anything that pop culture tells me you fight vampires with.
So you look inside her closet, and sure enough, you do find a shoebox, a little Reebok shoebox. And when you pry the lid off of it, sure enough, you find not any steaks or anything like that, because she's just a kid. Come on, Mindy. But you do find some vials of what looks to be, you know, it has a clear liquid in it, probably holy water, as well as a rope of garlic and a cross.
Nice.
I'm going to. Oh God, what are you doing?
I'm reading my cards. I know something. I'm
okay. Arms in one hand with the cross, in the other hand with the rope of garlic, ready at the door.
I don't know if it's gonna stop her. She sounds pretty strong.
I'm gonna stand in front of Ash and just.
Well, this could also all be complete hogwash.
You can hear something strange outside the window as well. Even though the wind is like really picking up now and the lights are flickering and at times going out altogether.
I'm seeing a lot of grief and trickery in our future.
Back downstairs, now that I sort of get myself together and I'm pissed off and I'm just gonna charge and try to hit her with the bat.
Okay, roll for it.
Because I see. She's going towards Roxy, right?
She's going up the stairs and at this point she's on the landing.
Okay, yeah. I'm gonna try to run, push past Roxy, and just hit her.
Okay.
And I'm pissed off now. You stupid bitch!
And then can you roll for it?
Roll my...
That was so creepy.
Eight.
So unfortunately, she just deftly kind of ducks and dodges it, and she turns around and kicks you with her steel-toed boot. It's gonna be that one. Ooh.
Uh-oh.
21. What's your guard?
My mage is 12.
So it definitely hits and you take 9 damage.
Okay.
As you go tumbling down the stairs.
Does anything happen to me?
You could say you start feeling a rage building up inside of you. Feeling this sort of, the danger is now descending on you. You're realizing you're in a situation that could be life or death. And you feel a strong need to defend these poor girls.
All right, I'm gonna get up, and then I guess I will use my alternate form feat.
Yeah, go for it.
And so, in a fit of rage, Reggie gets up and sort of his muscles start to grow to the point where he looks like he actually works out instead of smoking a bunch of weed, and his skin gets red and scaly as he spouts horns. Coming out of his head, and he doesn't know he's doing this because he's just looking down. And he just gets up and just like, you what the fuck even are you? And I sort of jump without realizing how strong I am and just try to tackle
her. What's going on?
Okay.
Do you see this?
She is faster than you.
No, I'm like just standing here in shock. Okay.
So she manages to dodge you. She looks a little bit surprised, not 100% sure with what she's looking at. And you suddenly feel another hand on the back of, on the nape of like your neck. And you realize the sound outside the window has now stopped. And instead, you've heard like a whooshing sound come in, busting through the front door, and or what was remains of the front door. And you see this Ryan character behind you, or rather, Roxy sees it.
Yeah.
You don't see him, and he pulls you from the nape of your neck and pulls you back. And Raven continues up the stairs, and into through the door.
I'm gonna pick up the bat and swing it at Ryan.
At Ryan, okay.
Yeah. Should I use my agility?
Yeah, I'd use agility.
Okay, mm-hmm. Good.
Definitely.
That's actually worth doing. Oh, yeah.
You're doing it.
I got a 15.
Okay. Are you going to use your full fonda?
My full fonda expired already because I put it on when I thought we were going to fight earlier. I know. So now I'm useless.
You do have one less physical.
Yeah, I guess I could use one.
You could use a wristband if you want.
Can I just add it right now?
Yeah, you can use them one at a time. Yep. They don't stack, so you can either use one or you wait till you have all
right.
Three. Yep.
But I mean, can I add it to the what I already rolled?
You can re-roll.
Okay, I'm gonna re-roll.
It'd probably be higher just because of the agility stat.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh yeah. I like that. Oh, it's 25. Yeah.
So you swing, and sure enough, it connects with his head. He immediately lets go of Reggie and recoils a little bit. And with that, we cut back to Raven. Since we're kind of going in a turn-based order here. Keeping initiative in my head, I swear.
Do you want us to...
The three of you should roll initiative since...
Yeah.
Do we roll just our d20s?
Mm-hmm. Your agility.
No,
agility.
Agility.
Yeah. No. Oh, I'm keeping that because that one's not terrible. Thank you. So plus agility.
Plus agility.
Oh, it's so our plus eight. Okay.
And then if you have lightning reflexes, that's advantage.
Oh yeah, I do have that. What does that add again?
Advantage is you roll.
Advantage is you roll two of the attribute die and then you keep the higher one.
Okay.
I got 28.
28?
18.
18?
19. 19.
I did explode, by the way.
Okay. Whoa!
Wow.
Those exploding dice. How else can you roll a 28 on initiative? So, the door opens, and sure enough, Raven is standing there. She does get to go first, however. How are you standing? So, you're in the middle of the room doing a reading.
Yeah.
AJ, were you by the window?
I'm actually in front of her, discarding her with my arms crossed.
And yeah, Lizzie's between at the door. Her and the door. Holding the cross and the garlic.
All right. She kind of chuckles at you with her little crooked smile and like brushes past you and sort of like, you almost like lose sight of her for a moment as she flits past you as well, Zeke. Something strange like shifts. And it's almost as though she moves like with a weird speed and almost etherealness as she flits past you. And it's almost like she was there and then she wasn't. And sure enough, she's standing behind Ash. She makes her way past you without you being able to do anything about it. And she grabs you from the back of your head by your hair. What do you do in your desperation?
In my desperation, so Ash doesn't actually know that she has any kind of
reach inside of you.
Magical
what
abilities. And in this moment, she's never been so scared for her life or for her friend's life. And something just kind of clicks and sparks. And all of us, and she's just kind of talking to herself like, oh God, what do I do? What do I do? And then at that moment, a little beast appears to protect her and her friends.
Out of the closet, the open closet where the Reebok shoe was, you see a little like ball come tumbling out, and it's almost like an ethereal white color. It immediately comes like zipping out and slams against Raven's leg and then uncoils, and it's a fuzzy little hedgehog. And Raven just quickly is like, what the heck? And like kind of like kicks the thing aside, except it like poof, like almost like turns into mist, coalesces, and then reappears next to you. And with the slamming into her leg and sort of the spininess of it, Raven does let go of your hair. And
I'm like super surprised. I don't know what's happening. But in that moment, I'm going to take the opportunity to try to grab her and throw her.
Grab what?
Raven.
Raven and throw her?
Okay. I have no idea where the hedgehog came from. I'm just okay. Like, what the hell is that? That's so cute. Not that I care.
Okay, I'm going to have you do an agility check.
Okay. Yeah.
So, being knocked off guard a little bit by this strange ethereal creature that hit her in the sort of the calf, and sort of being startled by that, you do push her, and she stumbles backwards and falls out of the window, out of the hole in the window.
No! Didn't want to do that. Okay.
What do you do?
What, should we go after her? What's going on? And then, like, at the same time, I'm kind of, like, taken by this little creature, and I go over to it.
It's now flitting around your ankles.
It's floating around my ankles?
Mm-hmm. It comes and perches on your shoulder.
Professor, what is happening?
I
kind of pet it as I'm asking. I mean, it's really, it doesn't seem like it's...
move?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It doesn't seem like it's harm, like dangerous, but.
I'm going to attempt to touch it. Does my finger touch it? Or like, is it corporeal or incorporeal?
It's incorporeal. When anyone but Tara touches it. Or when it wishes to be corporeal.
I mean, I can pet it. Like, look, it's like just hanging out on my shoulder. What's happening? This is crazy. Everything is crazy.
Did you do this?
I don't know.
While they're arguing, I'm gonna run and actually jump out the window as well.
Okay.
Zeke!
So are you gonna use your special ability?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you wanna describe that for the audience?
Yes, pretty much as you see him jump out, he becomes mist for a second and then reappears in the shell at the very ground floor.
Do we see that?
If you look really carefully, you might see me just be gone. And then upon landing, I'm gonna be on one knee looking around to see if the girl Raven's still there.
She's not there. She's disappeared.
I'm gonna shout, come out wherever you are. I invoke the Shadow Accords. This place is not yours anymore. Leave this girl alone. She's under my protection.
And out of nowhere, you suddenly, what's your guard?
My guard is 22, 24. Oh, sorry, that's hit points. 16.
Oof, sucks for you. You take 4 damage as you feel like, almost like claws, but they're not claws. It's almost like she's wearing like a chainmail kind of gauntlet. And as it like, as she suddenly just see something reappear behind you.
Oh!
I use bust a move.
You use bust a move? Okay.
Yes. Hurts to watch.
I know it does. It's really painful to watch.
Is that the 2 at a time?
No, it's only 1 at a time, but makes me incorporeal.
Makes you incorporeal.
Yeah.
So she misses as you go incorporeal, as you suddenly like out of nowhere, she appears and takes a swipe at you. And she then like kind of chuckles and says, shadow accords don't work when you're only half shadow.
Girly, girly, I don't know what you're doing, but you watch way too many pop movies. And I'm gonna actually stomp on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
Use it as a teleport shadow to kick on the side. So that's gonna be an agility check.
Mm-hmm.
Are we looking out the window at this point? Can we see any of
well,
this?
Well, he did leap, and I do expect that to kill him, so.
We're looking out.
Yeah, look out the window.
So, do we see him fighting her?
All you see is weird shadows flitting back and forth.
Where did Zeke go?
Do they hear the dialogue?
A little bit, maybe. Right.
There well,
it's
19 plus 13.
Two floors down, and they're not exactly 32. Shouting.
Oh, I had another explosion. It was 19 plus 13.
19 plus 32.
13. Yeah, I had one explosion.
You do manage to hit her, but she's not very swayed by it.
I don't suppose we could, you know, talk this out like proper people.
You just like almost see a shadow kind of pass in front of your eyes And with that, she's gone, and you hear a commotion once again from upstairs.
Oh, dad name it.
And meanwhile, Ryan, like Nanook, by the way, is going crazy in the yard this entire time, baying at the top of his lungs. And the wind is still rushing around the house at top velocity. By the way, I've used my second my sunglasses at night, so that's why they're going. It's going this long. I had two of them. I'm using both.
They're really cool. You should try and wear them all the time.
No.
I'm really jealous.
I'm pretty jealous.
Only like you know when it's not you know like.
I like the bonus to all my rolls.
Yeah.
And Ryan is back on his feet and immediately sort of tries to like swipe at you.
Okay.
Takes a punch.
I'm gonna duck under. I'm assuming I need to
What's
duck
your guard?
Head. What?
What's your guard?
13.
13. Fortunately, it's a static number, so. Oh, he misses. You're very dodgy right now.
Okay.
So he takes a swing at you, but you do duck underneath it.
As I duck under, I'm gonna reach into my fanny pack. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna use my blinded.
Okay.
I'm gonna reach into my fanny pack and grab a handful of glitter makeup.
Yes.
And throw it right into his eyes.
Okay.
Like right into his face.
Okay. And can you, I think you need to roll to invoke that.
So basically it just reduces his guard.
Yep.
So I roll my agility against it, which is pretty solid.
Yeah, I was gonna say, and you have your plus one.
Right. It's only a 12. With
a
12.
Okay, so the makeup does fly into his face.
It's glitter, by the way, which really hurts.
Yeah, it's glitter. And he does kind of sneeze and look vaguely annoyed, but he's not blinded.
Damn it.
And then from suddenly out of nowhere through, like, you hear your bedroom's window shatter. And Raven, once again, rematerializes almost in the upper flight landing and makes her way back through the bedroom window, or the bedroom door.
Where's Reggie at this point?
He's still on the stairs. You can take an action if you'd like to.
I need some help.
I'm just gonna come up and take a swing then at Ryan.
At Ryan, okay.
Haymaker. And I'm gonna use one of my munchies to, now that we know about the Hulk mode, you know that the munchies when I'm in Hulk mode, or when I'm in all scaled and horned out, it's plus one might instead of plus one presence.
Okay, so go ahead and use them.
So I'm gonna use the munchies. So that, I need to actually get an official open ruling. Now that my might is six, I don't know how many dice to roll.
It gets upgraded by one.
It's a
D8,
isn't it?
Yeah, it's a D8.
It's a D8 now.
Oh, nice. So it's two D8s then?
Yeah. Wait.
No. So you go from
five,
2D6
five is 2D6s. So is it a D6 and a D8 or two D8s now?
Oh. Two D8s.
Okay.
Crazy.
Damn it, only 15.
Okay. Well, 15 isn't, like, you hit him, but he's not too winded by it. So you get him in the back of the, sort of in the side of the head because you're swinging at him from behind. He is a little bit distracted from having glitter thrown in his face, so you do connect, but he quickly recovers and kind of like whirls around to meet you.
Now I also have the Battlefield Sentinel feat, which lets you take an additional opportunity to attack per round for each tier.
Okay.
And I only have one.
Okay, so go ahead.
So I'm just gonna basically come up with the other cross.
Okay.
So now I'm back down to five, so that's easier to deal with. Loading. 24.
24.
Yeah.
Nice.
So this time you manage to connect in a proper way, and he goes reeling back and sort of stumbles over some, like over a couch that's, you know, in your living room since you're fighting. Like you have your living room down here and your stairs going outside. And he goes reeling back and actually stumbles over the couch and falls backwards. And Raven enters the living room, the bedroom once again. And immediately sort of in her sort of fit of rage makes two attacks, immediately kind of like rushing past I keep wanting to call you Lizzie, and it keeps making me sadder. Immediately rushes past Mindy, kind of like knocking her inside. Whoops. Better. 17. What's
my
your guard?
Evasion is 13.
13. So she connects, and you take 4 damage.
No!
And you get pushed aside a little bit as she rushes past you. And she immediately, with her other arm, punches you across the face, Ash.
Can I do anything? We can't respond, can we?
No, you just have a static evasion. I am going to use my GM reroll and reroll that. I didn't like that.
You really want to beat up Ash, huh? Mm-hmm.
Everyone hates Ashley.
All right, 17. Ash.
I have a 15 evasion.
Okay, so she does connect and she clips you
how
in
much,
the face.
How much damage?
2.
2 damage.
Okay.
I'm going to, in response, again, this is like pure emotion. Keep my cards. Just yell at her and say, stop! And with that, I'm going to invoke my immobilizer.
Mm-hmm.
So I need to obviously roll. That'll be my d20 plus d10, because I don't know what I'm doing. So it's all pure emotions at this point. 17.
It does work, and she kind of freezes in time and looks very perplexed in this moment.
So for our viewers, I render my foe incapable of movement. Mm-hmm. In case you were wondering what that means. Cool. So she cannot move from space or until I release her. She pulls out, okay.
Yeah, I could resist it on the next turn.
Right, you could.
I probably will, because I have my sunglasses.
I know. Just give me my moment.
Okay, jeez. She stopped.
She stopped.
Mid-air, and after hitting you, her fist sort of stays in the air.
And I'm kind of freaked out. Like, Professor, what is going on?
I do not know. However, we should get out of this room. But before we do, Mindy, I grab her by the hand and dig my hand into my bag with the other. And if we are able to get to the door
before
she's...
Are you going to put garlic on her or something?
That did not seem to work.
Oh.
And if we can get past her and to the door of the bedroom before Raven unthaws, I'm going to toss the vial onto the floor and use my barrier boon. As the liquid spills out over the floor, it kind of congeals into this gross, sticky substance.
I love it.
When Raven is going to have to move, well, I mean, unless she can just leap all the way through the door, she would have to go through it and move at half speed.
Okay,
so she might. Yes.
Sounds good.
Does my little hedgehog friend want to do anything? Because
I don't know. He's still on your shoulder.
Okay.
Nibbling your ear.
Oh. You're gonna just hang out with me for a while. Don't worry.
You rendered her immobile, so he didn't feel the need to help out.
Right. Well, I don't. I'm still taking this all in. So.
But you get plus one to your, like, willpower, because he's doing a really good job of cheering you on.
Aww. Oh. I'm picturing yours. Of your little hedgehog.
My chubby little creature.
Yeah, absolutely.
It was the first creature that came to my head.
I love it. I was kind of expecting that, to be honest.
I'm the worst.
Hedgehog hero.
So as you trash down the vial, both of you leave the room, and suddenly the wind roars almost deafeningly and then dies down and the lights start to flick on and be stable. And
I'm still downstairs.
Is it?
Well, they're at the flight, they're outside the room, on the flight or the landing at the top of the stairs now, so they do see you.
Okay. I'm not like underneath in the living room.
And
they can see you from up there.
Do you still look? I mean, it doesn't matter. Mindy is going to scream.
Okay.
I'm gonna just kind of turn at them and be like, "Everyone, you okay?"
Wow. You look crazy.
What?
You're like big and strong looking. And you're not supposed to look like that.
I look at my hands. What
is wrong with everybody? What?
Dude. What the heck is going on?
I don't know.
We have to get out and she is going to unfreeze. We cannot stand here.
Why is she even frozen?
What the fuck? Is this?
What happened
to
your...
What's on my head?
Are those horns?
Are they?
Do you have horns?
Yeah, he was really strong too. It's weird.
We
should get out of here.
Like kind of dying down, the lights sort of stabilizing and not flickering as much anymore. Roxy, you go and look over the couch and notice that Ryan has disappeared. And outside you hear, now the roaring of the wind is replaced with the roaring of 12 motorcycles. And you hear Rick's cool voice like kind of float on the breeze. And he just says, Raven. And Raven, like, not that you can see it, is now once again outside. She looks like she's exited through the window.
Guys, what just happened?
Where is Zeke?
He's down below the window. What he does see is almost like a strange winged creature fly above his head very quickly when the voice calls out for her.
I'm just gonna cross my arms a little bit and back up into nothingness and appear close to the tree and just watch.
Okay. Wow. You see 12 motorcycles lined up outside, and all of a sudden you see Raven kind of get onto her bike in line with everyone else, looking a little sheepish, looking a little ashamed. And Rick gets off his bike and kind of like looks in through the front door, not crossing the threshold, and looks up at the strange scene in front of him, almost not wavering even for a moment upon seeing Reggie. And then he just says, sorry for the disturbance tonight. It won't happen again.
You bet it won't. I tackle him.
You can't.
Okay, I try to tackle him. So I just, boom.
That's one of the few GM times I'm like, you're so far across
straight
the room.
Straight up, no.
Because you're like up by the staircase, and he's all the way by the entrance of the door, and he didn't cross the threshold.
Oh, yeah. So I'm still downstairs, right?
Huh?
I'm still downstairs.
You are, but it's so far away.
Okay.
It would be like two movement.
So I would basically be flying out the door and then letting fly it outside.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which
okay.
is crazy.
So that's what I do.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Some things never change.
It's like you can't do that in one turn.
Brute and bloodlust are both part of my descriptors for this form. So
okay.
like I have to do this.
Okay.
But then after falling, I just sort of like now curl up in the fetal position outside. Just cold and
confused. Yeah. And he just like says as he's like turning around to leave, he says, Raven can get emotional sometimes.
Do you have the girl or are you
Where's Alex?
Creepy?
He doesn't respond.
Is he like, he's like walking away from us now, mm-hmm. right? I'm gonna try and chase him down.
Can I send my little hedgehog after?
Run after him.
You can. Are you gonna send it as a spy?
Oh, that's
okay.
cool.
Little
I don't know about that though, so I'm still gonna start walking, like trying to chase after him.
I don't know what you are or where you came from. Well, I know you're a hedgehog, but are you a hedgehog? I don't think you are. But can you like help us out if you can do that? I don't know if you can do that, but if you can, that'd be really great. That'd be super rad.
You see her flip, like just very quickly, almost turn into like ether, and then you see like a small creature, just like a small, just like ethereal wave go up, and then you see, only you see it. One of the bikers' sort of like biking bags, like the saddle bags on the side of the bike, you see her little head pop up and look at you and then go back down.
Aww. I am dying from how cute that is.
I am not,
I'm
adorable.
Like totally like holding it together.
And they get on their bikes. You're not like, as you're running through, you're not suddenly able to move anymore. You almost feel frozen. Yeah. As Rick just tells you, calm down.
Not getting calm.
And he gets back on his bike, and they kick off, and they leave. And as their bikes go further in the distance, the roaring stops. It sort of quiets down. And you see Zeke kind of walk up the front stairs after having witnessed all of this by the large tree.
Where have you been, Zeke? How did you get outside?
How did you survive the jump?
He jumped out the window?
There's so many things. You are horned. You...
There are things coming into your house.
So,
and you had a hedgehog? Where the hell did you get that hedgehog?
I have no idea.
I guess this is probably a good time for me to start explaining things, isn't it?
Yes.
You know things?
Yes. You know things?
I look up at Zeke and then there's tears on my face. Do you know what's happening to me?
Oh.
Actually, I kind of do.
Thank God. Now would be a great time to explain.
Let's just say that the 80s has brought about a new era of weirdness. So.
Everybody knows that.
That we're God living in it.
And with that...
No, I want to know.
I want to know too.
We come to the end of the second episode of The Outcrowd.
You had horns.
I had horns.
Dude, that was
I
have
a hedgehog.
Yes. I didn't know you knew things.
Those things. Invoking shadow accords and shit.
I know, yeah, that was right? Funny.
So we all we don't all know what we all can do.
I'm really upset that I'm
discovering as you go along.
It's fun.
It is really fun.
Yeah, I like knowing as we go along what we're actually able to do and stuff.
I did not know you even had those.
I'm not gonna lie, that episode did not go how I think it was gonna.
Don't you know
the weirdest thing?
We're the party that
you
literally
guys,
pulls a 180 on you.
Yeah, you guys do the weirdest things. I'm like, what are you guys doing right now?
Do you expect anything else from us?
Even when you game with us for months, you still don't expect us to do the crazy shit that we do.
I know.
That's how crazy.
I love it.
All right, let's read these things off.
Thank you, chat.
Thank you.
All right, so... We have $10 from Embly towards the hashtag cassette. Almost couldn't say cassette tape. Nice. Cassette, bust a move, AJ.
Yeah.
$18 from William TW. Here's a little buffing across the board from Neonec.
Thank you.
Thank you.
$17 from Heretic Rada. Hashtag Mindy needs rerolls badly. Fast talking is hard.
$10
from Brownie. For being a woman in a man's world, keep your chin up, Professor. Hashtag Mindy.
Aww, that was
soup a lot. $50. Hashtag sunglasses. Y'all are doing great.
Thank you.
$20 from Geica. Hashtag Neonet helps out for hashtag snack.
Get your snacks on.
Thank you.
$50 from RJ Canuck for a hashtag sweatband.
Thank you.
$7 from Aradinsk. Yay for the out crowd. You've all been killing it the past 2 weeks. Here's for hashtag Roxy needing more rerolls. Hashtag whooshing. $5 from Whitney VDM. Ash, I support you. Whiteout is way better than ivory anyway. It doesn't kill innocent elephants.
Thanks, Whit.
$12 from Celadare. Hashtag Ashley hype. $50 from Working Class Hero. Good luck with the seance. Hashtag candle. $10 from Delta Fate for Ash. And then $20 from Jabberwocky D. Hashtag Ashley, I think you might need this.
I got myself into a little trouble there.
You did.
Tiny bit.
You did. You messed with the wrong one.
Oh my God.
She was kind of mean.
She was a little mean.
A little mean.
She was a lot mean.
She was a lot mean.
Y'all got to wallop Kiefer Sutherland, though.
Yeah, that's true.
But there's so many NPCs.
I thought I was fighting.
That's what I was gonna say. When you actually create the NPCs, of course you're gonna like them.
I don't like Ryan or Biff.
Yeah,
he's
Ryan's
the worst.
I thought.
Wait, isn't it Rick Kiefer Sutherland?
Huh? Oh, I don't remember. Okay. But describing and then in my head whether or not it was true.
Who?
When you described Ryan, whether or not it is true, I immediately pictured Kiefer Sutherland.
That's not him.
I was pushing it's the kid who plays Bill and Bill and Ted, right?
Yeah, he got it.
I watched Lost Boys the day before we started this because I knew what was coming.
I'm sorry. So a lot of it's original, but a lot of it is
inspired.
My own... stuff that I like for it, but I'm gonna do callbacks.
You have to do callbacks.
I mean, if we don't, it's not really an 80s thing.
Yeah.
Right?
That's the fun of it.
I gotta do the callbacks.
Yeah. Totally.
But, it was good. It was good shit. I liked it.
I hope you guys had fun.
You guys are crazy, though. The things you guys do, I'm like, why would you do that? And then I'm like, okay, this is fine. You know what? I'm like, this is fine because I'm the GM now, so I'm not a player that's like, what are you guys doing? Which was me before. It would be like, what are you guys doing?
See, now we're back
to GM. I'm like, whatever, it's your lives. You freaking
you
do that. Good luck to you.
Tossing that firebomb, I think, was my favorite moment of the whole. Like, they were walking away.
Yeah, if you hadn't, I think maybe there wouldn't have been combat this episode.
Okay, but think about it. I am like a teenager. I'm angsty.
No, totally.
Like,
I'm into it.
I was just like, Scoop, you jerk. And I'm like, I have something. I don't know what it does. I was just role playing. Excellently.
Excellently.
I loved it. I loved it. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much.
Now we have to wait till next Monday to learn everything.
Next Monday.
You guys better be there.
Yes.
I'm ready to learn things.
Thanks
ready
for joining
to learn
us.
What you know.
Thank you to our wonderful, our wonderful players.
Thank you to our wonderful GM.
Yeah, you guys can.
Okay, congratulations again on 1 year. Everybody blow up Bronze's Twitter.
Thank you. And
chat
Thank
with
you.
Tonight.
It's been crazy. I was like doing the math. It's been over one unique
That's
sub
crazy.
A day.
Wow.
One calendar year, yeah, because you just cracked 450 subs.
That's awesome.
It was insane. I was
that's
just
awesome.
Like, that's more than one unique person a day that's like, I like this person.
That's crazy.
Made me a little misty-eyed yesterday.
Aw.
Wow. On next, we have HeroClix. Do feel free to give us your feedback in the Discord. We all use Twitter. We're all on Twitter. Feel free
Love
to tweet
Twitter.
Us stuff that you enjoyed, that you didn't enjoy. And that's it. We'll see you guys next Monday
hashtag.
At 6 p.m. Have a
hashtag.
Wonderful night.
Hashtag
stay
out
safe
yes.
and stay rad.
Lots of action.
Stay rad, y'all. Outcrowd.
Stay rad.
And hashtag stay rad.
Seems like an appropriate thing
it
to
is.
Say.
It is. Rad is the absolute appropriate word.
Totally.
Hashtag outcrowd. Hashtag
stay rad.
Stay rad.
Bye.